Lane about a week ago to 2 weeks ago. So on February 8th, we have an evening planned where we're inviting businesses in the area to come up to the school. February 8th at 6 p.m., we're going to be in the AV room. And we're going to, we have a speaker coming in, Patrick Miner from Golden Pathway Solutions, and he's going to give some information on how businesses can upload their information into a database that Mrs. Olson uses when she's working with kids for career interests.
So, cause I remember you guys talking about that. What is so important about this database that you're talking about? Like, why would they want to do that?
You betcha. So here's the deal. If we want to go to Mrs. Olson's webpage,
here, let's pull that up really quick here.
So what Mrs. Olson does is she starts to work with kids in upper elementary and then throughout, of course, junior high and high school, right? But starts in upper elementary, starts to start to have the kids do some career development. They start to take some interest inventories. She does four-year planning for high school. What are your classes are you taking? How do those classes transfer to any kind of job interests and things like that that you have? Mm-hmm. So the online database that she uses, and again, if you want to check this out, go to her webpage under the school staff counselor, Mrs. Krista Olson. And if you go down, you got, are you ready? This is the really big, big database. Mm-hmm. It's been around for a long time. It's really turned into a very nice database. So in here is where kids start to do high school planning, college planning, financial aid planning. You build a portfolio, and that takes years to build. That's why she starts so young. And then there's a career planning option, part of that that takes place too. So what? But in this database, and how this is important for this event coming up on
February 8th. It's important
8th,
to the businesses.
Yep. Yes, is this Compass profile. Mm-hmm. Okay, and I'm not going to click on it because I don't have a login anymore because I'm not a counselor anymore. But this in the Compass database, the kids take their interest inventories. It stores all of this stuff, right?
Okay,
it
so
stores,
anything they're interested in, any yes, kind of job possibility.
Totally, yep. And they're taking valid interest inventories, work-based mm-hmm. inventories, things that have been around for a long time, things that businesses have been using for decades. They've been tweaked to fit to the new mold of the economics and economies of the 21st century. Yep. So again, it builds all this, and it based on how you answer these questions, it starts to align certain career pathways with what your interests are, right? Mm-hmm. And as time goes on, maybe that is very solid with the student where you're always strong in egg sales.
Yeah.
Or you're always strong in medicine, right? Mm-hmm. And some kids, it changes every year because they're experiencing life and things change, right?
Yep.
So ultimately, where how this comes down to this Patrick Miner mm-hmm. and the night of February 8th is Golden Solutions is the entity that's in this Compass database that gathers information from businesses mm-hmm. and uploads it into here. So when a kid gets to the point, sophomore, junior year, mm-hmm. where they have opportunities to do work-based learning, where they're taking an hour of the academic school day and going out and trying to find a job that is based upon
their
all
interests.
Of these interests yep. that are in this database.
Yep.
That it'll actually have information on businesses in our area here.
Yep. So the when they're looking for jobs, it's like, hey, guess yep. what? They're just around the corner.
Exactly. Rather than us sitting here and going, well, who could we call? This kid is interested in sales, but it's not egg sales. Who could we call? You know, mm-hmm. so, and that's what we've been doing for a long time is just making those phone calls and those connections and saying, hey, Kyle up at Kennedy's, do you have any positions open for this? Or, you know, calling Norris down at West Plains. Do you have any, could you use a kid for an hour today to kind of show them this, right? And throughout town. What this does is it lets you as the business owner, you upload your information through the Golden Pathways.
Which isn't
this.
A lot of information.
It's not
quite a bit, but you get put into this
exactly
this system.
Yeah. So that mm-hmm. way when the kid hits results, boof.
Yep. It's like, oh dang, yep, it's right yep, in my own town.
Exactly. Here's your results, right? So the benefit of this is that hopefully one, we're giving these kids an opportunity at a minimum for some job shadowing experiences, right? That are directly tied to their interest inventories. Mm-hmm. Streamline that process. So at a minimum, hopefully we can get an hour or two or whatever, right? Depending on the business. There's yep. We're not going to make you commit to 40 hours of this.
Of course.
Or 400 hours of that. Mm-hmm. Anything is better than nothing. Mm-hmm. So at a minimum, we can get some job shadow experiences. Second part is hopefully we can help businesses find future employees to help them with any need that they have. Because as we're all well aware, it's very hard finding people right now that to fill positions that are open.
Yep.
And ultimately, in the end, one of the biggest things that I hope happens is it connects our local businesses with somebody that will be turned into a long-term employee, mm-hmm. and possibly someone to transition your business to when you're ready to retire.
Just promoting the longevity of the businesses that already exist.
Correct. Exactly.
Tying the future with the current.
Yes, and that's why we're connecting this. That's why we're advertising this as connecting your future with our students' future, because we're looking for some short-term wins, but we're also looking for some long-term wins for the benefit of our community.
Mm-hmm. And the kids.
And the kids, exactly, and our current local business owners. So that way we are no longer shuttering the doors of these businesses, mm-hmm. but hopefully we're finding a transition point to where there's someone there who's ready to take over when you're ready to retire.
Gotcha. So basically by a business just getting involved in this thing,
yep.
getting their info in there, they're helping that process. That correct. That quick little extra is going to be able to correct. Help us
yep.
bridge that yep. a little bit better.
Yep. And that's truly, those are our biggest wishes out of this thing. Mm-hmm. So again, I know on the invite it said RSVP by today, and again, hopefully we'll get this up today. Mm-hmm. We'll RSVP all week. Yep. I have a list where we're going to start calling businesses to make sure that, hey, are you sure you don't want to come to this? Mm-hmm. And it's going to take up 45 minutes to an hour tops.
Really fast.
Yep. Very fast. Very fast. We'll have some coffee and stuff just to kind of chill out, mm-hmm. ask some questions of Mr. Miner. And then we will have a lab open to where if you decide that night, yep, I want to do this. I want my information.
Yep.
We'll have one of our computer labs open upstairs.
And we can kind of hold your hand exactly. through the process. But if you yes. want to do it on your own, you can do it on your own too.
Yes, if you want to do it on your own, or if you want to think about it and ask some private conversations or ask some questions privately when there's not such a big group, that's fine too. Because
yep.
we can always help you later on down the road. But my big thing is I haven't heard Patrick Miner talk yet. I know Mrs. Olson has. I don't want people to feel that it's a huge commitment. This mm-hmm. commitment is totally based on each and every business in the area
yep.
and what works for you, you mm-hmm. know, and if job shadowing, if that's all you're willing to commit to right now, hey, that's beautiful.
Yep.
That's perfect. And if you want to go all in and do internship types of things or offer more longer job shadows that may, you know, be everyday kind of a thing and yep. maybe does have some pay for the kid, we're okay with that as well. So ultimately, you know, we're going to try to streamline it to fit everybody's needs. So.
Awesome. So if you know, if you are a business owner or know anybody that's a business owner, please make sure that you either get this video to whoever needs to see it or even call the school if you have any questions. Darren, gotcha. Anything else you want to?
No, mention? I hope this works. If this night doesn't work for you and you're sitting there, hey, I want to be a part of this, but I cannot come on February the 8th. Mm-hmm. Like you mentioned earlier, we will come to your business. We'll talk about it. We'll help you every step of the way. Ultimately, we're trying to do this for our youth, and we're trying to do it for our community. So,
awesome. All right. Well, thanks for clicking on this video. And if you have any questions, let us know. Thanks.
Thanks, Joe.
Hello, Hettinger area, the great state of North Dakota, the United States, and the world. This is Ted Uecker coming live from West River Health Services Foundation. Just wanted to let you know about the upcoming Giving Hearts Day activities for our nonprofit 501c3 nonprofit organization. Giving Hearts Day is the largest online giving day in the state of North Dakota. We are a member of the Impact Foundation, which allows us to participate with Giving Hearts Day. We're very excited about Giving Hearts Day. In the last 5 years, you've helped us raise almost $1.5 million for our healthcare system here in Southwest North Dakota. This year, our matching funds are $120,000. So our first goal is to match the match and raise another $120,000. You're probably wondering, how can I help? Well, it's pretty simple. You can give a gift of $10 or more to our West River Health Services Foundation in two ways. One, you can write out a check to WRHSF, and in the memo section, please write Giving Hearts Day. Or, if you'd rather give by credit card, you can go online anytime between now and February 8th to givingheartsday.org and then search West River. We'll come up with all of our information and our exciting campaign for Giving Hearts Day. As a last reminder, I'd let you know about three amazing Giving Hearts events that we'll be hosting. Our first event is on January 26th in Scranton at the boys basketball game. We're calling this event Giving Hearts Night with the Nighthawks and Eagles as the South Hart Eagles boys basketball team comes to town in Scranton at 5:30 sharp. Then our second Giving Hearts Night is going to be in New England on February 1st. This Giving Hearts Night with the Tigers and Nighthawks will also feature amazing events and terrific fundraising. We have an amazing list of sponsors who are covering your admission free into the game. Also, we have sponsors covering all the t-shirts for all of the kids and fans who give from $50 to $100 or more. We also have little kids, boys and girls, playing at halftime of the JV game. Then between games, we'll have a comfy couch auction. And at halftime of the varsity game, we'll have former and current greats shooting free throws for pledges. So you can become involved with us, and we'd really appreciate your support of our West River Health Services Foundation for Giving Hearts Day. Onward.
Hawk Talk is the official podcast of Hedinger Public School, where we keep you in the loop with the latest school news, offer insider school board meetings, and dive deep into the educational experience our school provides for the students, parents, and tight-knit community. Take a minute to enjoy a clip from our most recent episode.
Welcome back to Hawk Talk, the official podcast of Hedinger Public School. I'm Joel Janikowski, your host, and we're here to keep you in the loop with the latest school news, offer insights on school board meetings, and dive deep into what makes our educational experience special to our students, parents, and our tight-knit community. Well, today's episode will be generally focused around sports. As you keep listening, you'll come to learn that it has to do with way more. It's about developing well-rounded students and helping them build those skills that they're going to use for the rest of their lives. Joining us in this episode is someone who not only understands the game, but also its significance to our students' lives. Say hello to John Kohler, our devoted athletic director and history teacher here at Hedinger Public School. Now, John is here to share his expertise on building strong teams, nurturing sportsmanship, and the vital role sports play in shaping well-rounded individuals. We will also go into things such as, you know, the ref shortage that's happening across the country, how you can stay up to date on Nighthawks sporting events by using the Our School calendar, and how you can tune into the game while it's happening with KNDC and the HPS Stream team. And remember, you can stay connected to Hawk Talk on any podcast platform that you listen to, whether it be Apple Podcasts, Spotify Podcasts, or even watching it on YouTube. So just make sure that you hit that subscribe or follow button so that way you don't miss any future episodes that we're doing. All right, now let's go into today's episode. And thank you very much for tuning in again. I'm sitting here with John Kohler. John Kohler, thank you very, very much for sitting down with us today to talk about some of these things that are really good reminders. How are you doing today, John?
I'm doing pretty good. How are you doing, Joel?
Doing pretty good. So some of the things that we kind of wanted to talk about that you mentioned to me before is that, you know, the sports season's coming up and, you know, it's been summer. It's been a little bit and we forget things. It's always good to have good reminders. And we were going to talk about setting expectations in sports and things like that. What were some of the main ideas that you did want to kind of cover today?
Well, we just want to talk about, you know, the proper expectations for behavior during games, matches, mm-hmm. you know, all that stuff. Mm-hmm. You know, really, what is the role of sports in education-based athletics? Mm-hmm. And, you know, the current reffing shortages and refs and just a couple updates and things about the season, you know, the upcoming seasons and maybe hit on, you know, the Our School calendar and how people can get that instantaneous thing from us
okay.
by using the Our School calendar.
Awesome. So with that, in our first segment, we're going to kind of talk about setting expectations. So what are some of the key expectations that you believe everyone involved in sports should probably be keeping in mind when it comes to whether being at the games or even at practice? What's that mentality that they need to be having?
Respect.
Just straight up respect.
Yeah. And that's a pretty wide ranging topic. Respect for your teammates, mm-hmm. you know, respect for your coaches, respect for referees, you know, and as fans, respect for everything. As coaches, respect the referees, respect everything. You know, so it really, everything comes down to respect. Mm-hmm. And we do a really good job with that, but it doesn't hurt to talk about it as well.
Absolutely.
You know, because, you know, when we're at practice and stuff like that, say, you know, football, volleyball, cross country, the ones that are going on now, you know, if you're going to respect, you know, if you want to be a good teammate, it doesn't matter if you're the star player as a senior or that freshman that is coming in, you respect each other.
Absolutely.
You know, you have that respect. And when you start breeding that culture of respect, the sport itself becomes, you know, more enjoyable, not just, you know, for the kids themselves, but it becomes more for the fans, the coaches, just everything becomes easier when you inject that common respect that you have for everyone and just common, you know, good manners, things like that. Hey, sir, on the ground, help them up.
Absolutely.
You know, you see that kid in practice who maybe hasn't gotten a drill right all week and all of a sudden they're nailing. It's like, hey, man, good job. Give that notoriety. But then on the flip side of that, also accountability. You know, you want to have the players, the coaches, the fans, everyone be accountable.
Now, if you enjoyed that conversation and would like to hear the rest of it, you can go and search for Hawk Talk HPS on Apple Podcasts, Spotify Podcasts, and of course, our YouTube channel. Now on to the rest of our broadcast.
Your Nighthawks girls basketball will be back in action shortly, but don't go anywhere. Stay tuned for an exciting lineup of content, including school news stories, streamer spotlight, Hawk Talk podcast previews, sports highlights, local announcements, and most importantly, special messages from our local sponsors who play a vital role in supporting this program.
The Hedinger Chamber of Commerce is a local business that supports other businesses in the Hedinger community. Their goal is to promote businesses and sponsor events in hope of attracting people to Hedinger while getting the community more involved. If you have questions about starting your business, an event, or want to find out more about the chamber, contact us at 701-567-2531 or visit us at 120 South Main Street.
Dakota Western Bank, your trusting partner since 1910, serving Hedinger, North Dakota, for personal banking with checking, savings, and auto loans for businesses in agriculture. They offer tailored services and digital solutions. Discover online banking applications and mobile options. This is our website for locations, hours, and career opportunities. Dakota Western Bank, where banking meets community, proudly serving Hedinger, North Dakota.
Need a place to keep your cash safe and secure? Come on down to Dakota Plains Federal Credit Union. We can get you your cash fast with our drive-through, which is open from 8:30 a.m. to 4:30 p.m., or you could come into the lobby, which is open from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. We've been serving the community since 1992, and we are located at 221 South Main Street. You can contact us at 701-567-2153.
Take the next minute to learn about some upcoming reminders and events for Hedinger Public School and the Hedinger community.
West River has been serving our community for over 40 years. Our agents are here to help you get your home, auto, farm, ranch, business, health, and crop insurance. We are located in the lower level of Dakota Western Bank. Swing by at 603 Adams Avenue or call us at 701-567-9378.
The HBS Stream Team is a school-to-work program in which students in grades 7 through 12 gain real-world experience while learning about the basics of live broadcasting and providing a service to our community. Now, let us take a moment to meet one of our members who help us make this possible.
Hey, everybody. Thank you very much for tuning in again to the Streamer Spotlight. Today, I have sitting with me is Brennan Friebel. Brennan, hi. Thank you so much for coming in and talking with us today.
Yeah, it's nice to be with you too.
Awesome. So we're bringing in students. If you haven't seen the Streamer Spotlight before, we bring in students to talk about basically, you know, who they are, so you can meet who the streamers are behind the cameras, behind the laptops, behind the mics, so you can meet those students, learn a little bit about them, and that way, you know, it provides a little bit more value and a little bit more depth behind the stream team and all the kids behind it. So first off, so Brennan, let's learn about you as a student. So you're a student here at Hettinger Public School for part of the day, correct? What classes are you in?
Sixth and seventh period. Mm-hmm. Both of your classes, video production and graphic design, and I'm also in choir.
Yep, absolutely. And you've been a joy to have part of those classes. You joined us last year, right?
Yeah.
Yep.
Not in graphic design though.
No, this is your first year for graphic design.
Yeah.
And Brennan came in last year and actually was not the winner but the runner up for the film festival last year when we did the video production and created a great film. You can find it on the HPS Stream Team YouTube channel called Brennan's Quest for Milk. It is a wonderful short film. But yeah, so your thoughts on those classes?
Well, video production is really great. Mm-hmm. It's the first one, obviously, so I'm going to hold off on memories to it.
Of course.
Mm-hmm. And graphic design is also great, but if I were to make a tier list, it'd be a bit under video production.
That's okay. That's right. I need the honesty.
And then there's always that one class you kind of like. Yay, I like this class, but also, oh, I don't really like this class. Yeah, that'd be choir.
Oh, that's all right, though, because it might challenge you a little bit, you know, and there's, you're still learning valuable skills in that class as well, and I've heard you sing, sound wonderful, you do a great job, so you provide value to that group as well, so that's wonderful. So another thing, too, that we'll kind of talk about is not only Brennan as a student, but also the stream team, Brennan's experience of the stream team, his impact and all that stuff. So Brennan, why do you like the stream team? What is the things that you enjoy about it?
Well, because I get to get out a lot more. I don't
it pulls you out of the home. You got some stuff to do. Absolutely.
And it also lets me, you know, get to know other people who work with me and have similar interests.
Absolutely. So you can kind of make some friends. And if I'm correct, you worked with Dakota Hibbard, and he's a good friend of yours.
Yeah, we're actually like childhood friends.
Okay, so good point. So it gives you another reason to hang out and be with your friends and all that stuff. One of the fun things that we like to do with the Streamer Spotlight is also just to kind of tell fun stories or just to kind of bring fun highlights about our streamers. And Brennan, since he's been part of our classes and obviously the stream team, has truly become kind of the neutral, chaotic energy. If you know Brennan, you know what I'm talking about. He's a very random individual, but it's very fun. As long as we can, you know, hold in the reins, it can be a very, very fun and entertaining experience being around Brennan. You don't really know what he's going to say, what's going to come out of his mouth, but it is never boring, that's for sure. And again, going back to his short film, if you watch that, you'll understand the creativity and randomness that he has. But I just want to say, Brennan, thank you very, very much for being on the stream team and being a part of the program and also part of the classes and all of that. So thank you very much. All right.
Waffle.
Bye-bye.
Your Nighthawks girls basketball will be back in action shortly, but don't go anywhere. Stay tuned for an exciting lineup of content, including school news stories, streamer spotlight, Hawk Talk podcast previews, sports highlights, local announcements, and most importantly, special messages from our local sponsors who play a vital role in supporting this program.
At Ag Pro Machine, we provide quality work and full-time service for ag and automotive equipment. We also have a large selection of parts and tools for your automotive and ag equipment. Call at 701-567-7500. Or you can also stop by east of Henniger along Highway 12.
Graphic Addict specializes in embroidery, screen printing, direct-to-garment printing, along with expert video and audio digitalization. Enjoy complimentary popcorn and explore over 50 flavors of delightful jelly beans when you visit. Don't miss out on gearing up for the upcoming sports seasons with our exclusive Nighthawk collection. Drop by Graphic Addict or call us at 567-3161 to discover the perfect fit for your style and needs.
Here at Kennedy's, we provide fresh goods and groceries for all your daily needs, ranging from our special selection of fruits and vegetables to our specially created delis and bakeries. Find us on 200 North Main Street or call us at 701-567-2404 to place an order.
Big deal with that subscribe button. It's not just for following our YouTube channel, it signifies much more. When you subscribe, you become a part of the HPS Stream Team, proudly supporting our vibrant program led by our students. Your subscription is a powerful statement, creating a positive ripple effect across our community and beyond. And don't forget, liking this video also sends a clear message to the students working this broadcast. It's a way to appreciate their hard work and motivates them to produce high-quality broadcasts. So, go ahead, show your support, like this video, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thanks for watching!
Welcome to West River Vet Clinic. Here, we aren't just your pet's healthcare provider, we're their second family. Our awesome vets offer everything from checkups to surgery. Plus, we've got great grooming. Here, we are big on preventative care to keep your furry friends happy and healthy. We also ensure a stress-free environment for both pets and their owners. For our services, you can visit westrivervet.com. You can find us at 203 US Highway 12 East or call us at 701-567-4333.
Your Nighthawks girls basketball will be back in action shortly, but don't go anywhere. Stay tuned for an exciting lineup of content, including school news stories, streamer spotlight.
Thank you. Vision Brilliant and Vivid 2-pack bulbs, save $10. They have NAPA Extended Life Cooling System, anti-freezing coolant for all makes, all models, ready to use, starting at just $9.99. Pick up your Howell's Fuel Additive Diesel Conditioner and Anagel, just $10.49. And Seafoam Concentrated Fuel Injector Cleaner, starting at just $4.49. Those and many more great deals, it's at NAPA Auto Parts and Egg Pro Machinery in Hettinger and Lemon, saying good luck, Nighthawks.
At Backyard Mechanics, they take care of you like family because they live here right in your neighborhood. Fixing cars is what they do, but keeping you on the road and keeping your family safe is what they care about. No matter what you drive, Backyard Mechanics will provide the security your family needs to keep you protected on the road. To learn more about what Backyard Mechanics can do... I trust them, and I think you should too.
Consolidated Business Solutions, along with GNET Fiber Technology and local support, can give your business the edge. Fiber solutions with symmetrical speeds up to 1 gig provide the fastest, most reliable internet available. Business Class Voice delivers custom options and plans to fit every business. And Consolidated's video keeps your customers informed and entertained. Contact our experienced team today.
Thank you.
expectations.
More than ever, your business or farm needs a local banker, a local insurance agent, a local team of advisors. Dakota Bank meets that challenge head on. Whether you need financing to operate and grow, insurance to reduce your risks, cash management and Visa card services, or trust and wealth management expertise, Dakota Bank is here for you. Call, click, or come in. Learn more at dakotabank.com or search online for business banking. Dakota Bank, member FDIC. Insurance and trust are not FDIC insured.
At Dakota Western Bank, they know ag banking. Found in 1910, their roots are tied to the land here in southwest North Dakota. They have the know-how to contribute to your success. They stand with you. Visit dwb.bank or stop by for a visit at one of our locations in Bowman, Rames, Scranton, Headinger, or Regent. Member FDIC, it's Dakota Western Bank.
These days, credit cards come in lots of colors.
Stars, stripes, platinum, plaid, but after that, they're all pretty much the same.
Not ours. At the credit union, we offer very competitive rates on our credit cards. That's a design feature that's easy. Members. Okay.
local announcements, and most importantly, special messages from our local sponsors who play a vital role in supporting this program.
Grand Honey is a family-run business that's been making honey in both North and South Dakota and selling it to customers for over 30 years. We make several pounds of honey seasonally, all 100% raw and natural. This includes both clover and creamed honey. If you want some honey, call 701-567-3439, go to dakotahoney.com, or take a right after the railroad tracks on Country Club Road, Hettinger, North Dakota, 58639.
Here at The Gutter, we provide a variety of food and entertainment. Make sure to enjoy bowling, pool, VR, table tennis, air hockey, and much more while we prepare your order. We have pizza, burgers, fries, dessert, drinks, and much more. You can find us by taking a left at the end of Main Street or call us at 701-567-6749.
KB Jewelers is not only a jewelry store, but they also contain a lot of other great things such as trophies, books, holiday decor, and more. When you're looking for gifts for family, friends, or if you want to look at some cool things, come on down. They're located on 206 South Main Street, Hettinger, North Dakota. You can contact them on their number 701-567-2358. They're open from 9 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. from Monday to Saturday each week. Come visit.
Welcome to the Peacock Mercantile.
We have been serving you since 2018. You can get baked goods like cookies, muffins, and pies. You can also get caffeinated beverages and non-caffeinated beverages. The Peacock is a nice place to socialize and meet new people. The Peacock also has refreshments like hot and cold coffee and smoothies. We are located at 213 South, Hettinger, North Dakota, 58639. You can reach us at 701-637-0102. Again, that was 701-637-0102.
The HPS Upload is a weekly broadcast of school news put on by the 7 through 12 video production class that provides coverage of recent events, sports, weather, and news stories. Now, let's take a look at the story from this week.
Last month, our high school students embarked on a new venture known as Lunch with the Hawks, a program designed to foster connections as they join elementary students for lunch. In an exclusive interview with both the high school participants and Ms. Olson, I learned more about how the program is developing.
I enjoyed it quite a bit, build connections with the younger students and hear what's all going on in the elementary. It's kind of fun. I visited with them about sports and what they like to do or what they did over the weekend or something like that, but just to make connections with them. I enjoyed it, yeah.
I thought it was fun to kind of see how like the dynamics of the lunchroom have changed but are also the same as when we were like that age, and just to like have a reminder of what it was like to be in like elementary.
Yeah, it was super fun being able to catch up with all the kids and hear their stories. It was super fun. After we were done eating and I was getting ready to leave, all the kids came up and gave a big hug and were like, bye, Miss Olivia. So it was super sweet to see that they enjoyed it.
I thought it was a good thing that the National Honor Society did this activity, and we're going to do it next month, so the kids are super excited for us. So
we look forward to continuing to do it.
What inspired the idea of having elementary students dine with high school National Honor Society students during lunchtime?
Okay, so the idea came about to do Lunch with the Hawks is what we're calling it, because a pillar of National Honor Society is service. And so we're always looking for things to give back to our community and our school. And so in doing so, we thought it would be a great idea to try to do something with the elementary. And the thought of just a simple thing as having lunch with them came to mind. Instead of taking a long period of time away from classes or anything, we can just go to the lunchroom, have social time with the kids, and eventually hopefully adding to that by having other groups join us doing this as well.
How do you believe this initiative benefits both the elementary and the high school students involved?
We've done this one time in January, and what I've seen is some amazing things.
where one of my NHS students walk in the room and they notice them from the basketball court or the wrestling mat or from playing volleyball, and these kids instantly want to sit with them. Like, please come sit by me. So it's fun to see the high school kids light up, like, oh, they recognize me, but also the little kids get excited to get to sit with them. We're gonna do a few changes this next time, adjusting how many students we have with each group to meet the demand of how many students are in the lunchroom at a time. But eventually some of the elementary kids want these kids to go outside to recess with them. So it's possible that one day, maybe in the spring, we can send the kids outside to recess. So that's, we're really looking forward to this project and how it's going to evolve over time.
Is there anything else you would like to add?
No, thank the elementary teachers and the high school staff for allowing us to do this project, and the high school kids getting some time away from class to go down and work with the elementary. So thank you very much.
As Lunch for the Hawks continues to bridge the gap between high school and elementary students, these shared moments of camaraderie promise a lasting impact on our school and community.
Your Nighthawks girls basketball will be back in action shortly, but don't go anywhere. Stay tuned for an exciting lineup of content, including school news stories, streamer spotlight, Hawk Talk podcast previews, sports highlights, local announcements, and most importantly, special messages from our local sponsors who play a vital role in supporting this program.
A better way of life is better days off and better nights in. Better hellos and better goodbyes. With locally approved, financed, and serviced home loans, Gate City Bank makes buying a home simple. Welcome home. Gate City Bank, for a better way of life.
Does your car have some body damage? Stop by Lakeside Auto Body, where we can take care of all your auto body needs. Whether it is dent removal or hail damage, they can fix it. They also have a wide variety of paints to choose from for partial or full body paints. You can find us at Hedinger 103 Highway 8 South, North Dakota 58639, or call us at 701-567-4380.
Welcome to the Adams County Library, where we have been serving the community since 1913. At the Adams County Library, you can not only check out books, movies, and audiobooks, but you can also check out laser tag and other fun games. We also have activities for the whole community every week. The library is open 3:30 to 5:30 Monday through Thursday, and you can find us at 103 6th Street North.
Attention, coaches, players, and fans. Here is a message from Nighthawk Nation.
We as Nighthawks expect you to follow these simple expectations.
Make sure to practice good sportsmanship. Please be respectful to all. Positive cheering goes a long way. And remember, we are just kids.
We all make mistakes.
To our coaches, remember to always encourage your players.
We all make mistakes, so for the players to stay focused on the game, as coaches, you should always talk positively to your players.
And remember to relax, let the players play, and the refs ref.
To all players,
leave a positive imprint on and off the field, court, mat, and track.
Work hard, play your role, and most importantly, have fun. It's just a game.
Fans, we need to see you at our sporting events, because without you, there is no excitement.
To make sure you stay at our games, please refrain from using bad language, no yelling at refs, coaches, and players.
Maybe you're yelling positive because you can't cheer if you're not here. So remember, be positive.
Are you suffering from arthritis or achy joints? Did you experience an accident or sports injury? Or do you need post-surgery rehabilitation? We can help. we offer the latest therapy treatments at West River Rehabilitation with physical, occupational, and speech therapy right here close to home. Begin your recovery with us today. We can help you feel better and live better. Call West River Rehab at 567-6044.
Thank you. Everything we do for you. Federally insured by NCUA.
Encompass Therapy has exciting news. We have added orthotics assessment and fitting to our clinic. Paul Hendrickson grew up in the area and is an experienced orthotics and prosthetics designer. He has a state-of-the-art fabrication lab right here in Scranton, North Dakota. He offers a wide range of the newest materials and techniques to make orthotics just right for you. Call 701-567-8910 today to make an appointment. Welcome, Paul Hendrickson.
wise and warm. Strong hands to guide you.
Farmers Union insurance agents are friends you can lean on, with one-stop security for yourself and those you love.
Safe in the feeling, you're never alone.
Call Kim Erickson at 701-567-4358, your local Farmers Union insurance agent of Hettinger. Haley J. Evans Accounting and Tax Services reminds you that they're here for you. Give Haley a call today at 567-2856. Haley J. Evans is here for your payroll and bookkeeping needs, along with tax and financial needs. Stop by her office at 123 South Main Street in Hettinger or call for an appointment today, 567-2856. Haley J. Evans Accounting and Tax Services, a proud Nighthawk sports sponsor. And the staff at Hettinger Family Dental are proud to serve the patients of Hettinger, Lemon, and the surrounding areas. They are a comprehensive dental clinic offering a wide variety of services, including dental cleanings, fillings, root canals, dentures, and much more. For all of your dental care needs or questions, call Hettinger Family Dental, 701-567-4302. That's Hettinger Family Dental, a proud Nighthawk sports sponsor.
Dr. Brody Peterson and the staff at Hettinger Family Dental are pleased to announce the addition of registered dental hygienist Kendrin Bullinger to their team. She's excited for the opportunity.
Ah!
surrounding areas. New patient exams and cleaning appointments are available Monday through Wednesday from 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. Call 567-4302 to schedule your appointment today. That's 701-567-4302 for Hettinger Family Dental.
Stop in this week to Kennedy's Fresh Foods of Hettinger. Convenience counts. Stop in. All shopping should be this easy. Their store hours Monday through Friday, 7 a.m. to 8 p.m., 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. on Saturday, 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. on Sunday. Great deals back in the meat department, deli department, also down the produce aisle and throughout the store. It's at Kennedy's Fresh Foods of Hettinger, proud supporters of Nighthawk Sports. Lakeside Auto Body and Glass reminds you they're here for you for all of your general auto body needs. From minor to major collision or windshield chip and full windshield replacement. Give Mark a call today at 567-4380. That's 5-6-7-4-3-0-2.
Hey everybody, thank you for clicking on this video. I just want to quick put out some really important information, especially for businesses. I have sitting here with me Mr. Darren Siemens. Darren, what's going on today? What's the announcement about?
All right, here we are. We have a opportunity coming up for local businesses. Those that are members of the Hettinger Chamber of Commerce should have gotten a copy of this flyer in a mailing about a week ago to 2 weeks ago. So on February 8th, we have an evening planned where we're inviting businesses in the area to come up to the school. February 8th at 6 p.m., we're going to be in the AV room. And we have a speaker coming in, Patrick Miner from Golden Pathway Solutions, and he's going to give some information on how businesses can upload their information into a database that Mrs. Olson uses when she's working with kids for career interests.
So because I remember you guys talking about that. What is so important about this database that you're talking about? Like, why would they want to do that?
You betcha. So here's the deal. If we want to go to Mrs. Olson's webpage.
Here, let's pull that up really quick here.
So what Mrs. Olson does is she starts to work with kids in upper elementary and then throughout, of course, junior high and high school, right? But starts in upper elementary, starts to start to have the kids do some career development. They start to take some interest inventories. She does four-year planning for high school. What are your classes? Are you taking? How do those classes transfer to any kind of job interests and things like that that you have? Mm-hmm. So the online database that she uses, and again, if you want to check this out, go to her webpage under the school staff counselor, Mrs. Krista Olson. And if you go down, you got, are you ready? This is the really big, big database. Mm-hmm. It's been around for a long time. It's really turned into a very nice database. So in here is where kids start to do high school planning, college planning, financial aid planning. You build a portfolio, and that takes years to build. That's why she starts so young. And then there's a career planning option, part of that takes place too. So but in this database and how this is important for this event coming up on February 8th.
Why it's important to the businesses.
Yep. Yes, is this Compass profile. Okay. And I'm not going to click on it because I don't have a login anymore because I'm not a counselor anymore. But this in the Compass database, the kids take their interest inventories. It stores all of this stuff, right?
Okay. So anything they're interested in, any kind of job possibility.
Totally. Yep. And they're taking valid interest inventories, work-based inventories, things that have been around for a long time, things that businesses have been using for decades. They've been tweaked to fit to the new mold of the economics and economies of the 21st century. Yep. So again, it builds all this, and it based on how you answer these questions, it starts to align certain career pathways with what your interests are, right? Mm-hmm. And as time goes on, maybe that is very solid with the student where you're always strong in egg sales or you're always strong in medicine, right? Mm-hmm. And some kids, it changes every year because their experience in life and things change, right?
Yep.
So ultimately, where how this comes down to this Patrick Miner and the night of February 8th is Golden Solutions is the entity that's in this Compass database that gathers information from businesses and uploads it into here. So when a kid gets to the point, sophomore, junior year, where they have opportunities to do work-based learning, where they're taking an hour of the academic school day and going out and trying to find a job that is based upon
all of these interests
that are in this database.
Yep.
That it'll actually have information on businesses in our area here.
Yep. So the when they're looking for jobs, it's like, hey, guess what? They're just around the corner.
Exactly. Rather than us sitting here and going, well, who could we call? This kid is interested in sales, but it's not egg sales. Who could we call? You know, so, and that's what we've been doing for a long time is just making those phone calls and those connections and saying, hey, Kyle up at Kennedy's, do you have any positions open for this? Or, you know, calling Norris down at West Plains. Do you have any, could you use a kid for an hour today to kind of show them this, right? And throughout town. What this does is it lets you as the business owner, you upload your information through the Golden Pathways.
Which isn't a lot of information.
It's not
quite a bit, but you get put into this this system.
Yeah. So that way when the kid hits results, boof.
Yep. It's like, oh dang, it's right in my own town.
Exactly. Here's your results, right? So the benefit of this is that hopefully one, we're giving these kids an opportunity at a minimum for some job shadowing. experiences, right, that are directly tied to their interest inventories. Mm-hmm. Streamline that process. So at a minimum, hopefully we can get an hour or two or whatever, right, depending on the business. There's not, we're not going to make you commit to 40 hours of this.
Of course.
Or 400 hours of that. Mm-hmm. Anything is better than nothing. Mm-hmm. So at a minimum, we can get some job shadow experiences. The second part is hopefully we can help businesses find future employees to help them with any need that they have. Because as we're all well aware, it's very hard finding people right now that to fill positions that are open.
Yep.
And ultimately, in the end, one of the biggest things that I hope happens is it connects our local businesses with somebody that will be turned into a long-term employee, mm-hmm. and possibly someone to transition your business to when you're ready to retire.
Just promoting the longevity of the businesses that already exist.
Correct. Exactly.
Tying the future with the current.
Yes, and that's why we're connecting this. That's why we're advertising this as connecting your future with our students' future, because we're looking for some short-term wins, but we're also looking for some long-term wins for the benefit of our community.
Mm-hmm. And the kids.
And the kids, exactly, and our current local business owners. So that way we are no longer shuttering the doors of these businesses, mm-hmm. but hopefully we're finding a transition point to where there's someone there who's ready to take over when you're ready to retire.
Gotcha. So basically by a business just getting involved in this thing, getting their info in there, they're helping that process. That quick little extra is going to be able to help us bridge that a little bit better.
Yep. And that's truly, those are our biggest wishes out of this thing. Mm-hmm. So again, I know on the invite it said RSVP by today, and again, hopefully we'll get this up today. Mm-hmm. We'll RSVP all week. I have a list where we're going to start calling businesses to make sure that, hey, are you sure you don't want to come to this? Mm-hmm. And it's going to take up 45 minutes to an hour tops.
Really fast.
Yeah. Very fast. Very fast. We'll have some coffee and stuff just to kind of chill out, mm-hmm. ask some questions of Mr. Miner. And then we will have a lab open to where if you decide that night, I want to do this. I want my information. Yep. We'll have one of our computer labs open upstairs.
And we can kind of hold your hand through the process. But if you want to do it on your own, you can do it on your own too.
Yes, if you want to do it on your own, or if you want to think about it and ask some private conversations or ask some questions privately when there's not such a big group, that's fine too. Because we can always help you later on down the road. But my big thing is I haven't heard Patrick Miner talk yet. I know Mrs. Olson has. I don't want people to feel that it's a huge commitment. This mm-hmm. commitment is totally based on each and every business in the area and what works for you, mm-hmm. and if job shadowing, if that's all you're willing to commit to right now, hey, that's beautiful. Yep. That's perfect. And if you want to go all in and do internship types of things or offer more longer job shadows that may be everyday kind of a thing and maybe does have some pay for the kid, we're okay with that as well. So ultimately, we're going to try to streamline it to fit everybody's needs. So.
Awesome. So if you know, if you are a business owner or know anybody that's a business owner, please make sure that you either get this video to whoever needs to see it or even call the school if you have any questions. Darren, anything else you want to?
No, mention? I hope this works. If this night doesn't work for you and you're sitting there, hey, I want to be a part of this, but I cannot come on February the 8th. Mm-hmm. Like you mentioned earlier, we will come to your business. We'll talk about it. We'll help you every step of the way. Ultimately, we're trying to do this for our youth, and we're trying to do it for our community. So,
awesome. All right. Well, thanks for clicking on this video. And if you have any questions, let us know. Thanks.
Thanks, Joe.
Hello, Hettinger area, the great state of North Dakota, the United States, and the world. This is Ted Uecker coming live from West River Health Services Foundation. Just wanted to let you know about the upcoming Giving Hearts Day activities for our nonprofit 501c3 nonprofit organization. Giving Hearts Day is the largest online giving day in the state of North Dakota. We are a member of the Impact Foundation, which allows us to participate with Giving Hearts Day. We're very excited about Giving Hearts Day. In the last 5 years, you've helped us raise almost $1.5 million for our healthcare system here in Southwest North Dakota. This year, our matching funds are $120,000. So our first goal is to match the match and raise another $120,000. You're probably wondering, how can I help? Well, it's pretty simple. You can give a gift of $10 or more to our West River Health Services Foundation in two ways. One, you can write out a check to WRHSF, and in the memo section, please write Giving Hearts Day. Or, if you'd rather give by credit card, you can go online anytime between now and February 8th to givingheartsday.org and then search West River. We'll come up with all of our information and our exciting campaign for Giving Hearts Day. As a last reminder, I'd let you know about three amazing Giving Hearts events that we'll be hosting. Our first event is on January 26th in Scranton at the boys' basketball game. We're calling this event Giving Hearts Night with the Nighthawks and Eagles as the South Hart Eagles boys' basketball team comes to town in Scranton at 5:30 sharp. Then our second Giving Hearts Night is going to be in New England on February 1st. This Giving Hearts Night with the Tigers and Nighthawks will also feature amazing events and terrific fundraising. We have an amazing list of sponsors who are covering your admission free into the game. Also, we have sponsors covering all the t-shirts for all of the kids and fans who give from $50 to $100 or more. We also have little kids, boys and girls, playing at halftime of the JV game. Then between games, we'll have a comfy couch auction. And at halftime of the varsity game, we'll have former and current greats shooting free throws for pledges. So you can become involved with us, and we'd really appreciate your support of our West River Health Services Foundation for Giving Hearts Day. Onward.
Hawk Talk is the official podcast of Hettinger Public School, where we keep you in the loop with the latest school news, offer insider school board meetings, and dive deep into the educational experience our school provides for the students, parents, and tight-knit community. Take a minute to enjoy a clip from our most recent episode.
Welcome back to Hawk Talk, the official podcast of Hettinger Public School. I'm Joel Janikowski, your host, and we're here to keep you in the loop with the latest school news, offer insights on school board meetings, and dive deep into what makes our educational experience special to our students, parents, and our tight-knit community. Well, today's episode will be generally focused around sports. As you keep listening, you'll come to learn that it has to do with way more. It's about developing well-rounded students and helping them build those skills that they're going to use for the rest of their lives. Joining us in this episode is someone who not only understands the game, but also its significance to our students' lives. Say hello to John Kohler, our devoted athletic director and history teacher here at Hettinger Public School. Now, John is here to share his expertise on building strong teams, nurturing sportsmanship, and the vital role sports play in shaping well-rounded individuals. We will also go into things such as, you know, the ref shortage that's happening across the country, how you can stay up to date on Nighthawk sporting events by using the Our School calendar, and how you can tune into the game while it's happening with KNDC and the HPS Stream team. And remember, you can stay connected to Hawk Talk on any podcast platform that you listen to, whether it be Apple Podcasts, Spotify Podcasts, or even watching it on YouTube. So just make sure that you hit that subscribe or follow button so that way you don't miss any future episodes that we're doing. All right, now let's go into today's episode. And thank you very much for tuning in again. I'm sitting here with John Kohler. John Kohler, thank you very, very much for sitting down with us today to talk about some of these things that are really good reminders. How are you doing today, John?
I'm doing pretty good. How are you doing, Joel?
Doing pretty good. So some of the things that we kind of wanted to talk about that you mentioned to me before is that, you know, the sports season's coming up and, you know, it's been summer. It's been a little bit, and we forget things. It's always good to have good reminders. And we were going to talk about setting expectations in sports and things like that. What were some of the main ideas that you did want to kind of cover today?
Well, we just want to talk about, you know, the proper expectations for behavior during games, matches, mm-hmm. you know, all that stuff. Mm-hmm. You know, really, what is the role of sports in education-based athletics? Mm-hmm. And, you know, the current reffing shortages and refs, and just a couple updates and things about the season, you know, the upcoming seasons, and maybe hit on, you know, the Our School calendar and how people can get that instantaneous thing from us.
Okay.
By using the Our School calendar.
Awesome. So with that, in our first segment, we're going to kind of talk about setting expectations. So what are some of the key expectations that you believe everyone involved in sports should probably be keeping in mind when it comes to whether being at the games or even at practice? What's that mentality that they need to be having?
Respect.
Just straight up respect.
Yeah. And that's a pretty wide ranging topic. Respect for your teammates, you know, respect for your coaches, respect for referees. You know, and as fans, respect for everything. As coaches, respect the referees, respect everything. You know, so it really, everything comes down to respect. Mm-hmm. And we do a really good job with that, but it doesn't hurt to talk about it as well.
Absolutely.
You know, because, you know, when we're at practice and stuff like that, say, you know, football, volleyball, cross country, the ones that are going on now, you know, if you're going to respect, you know, if you want to be a good teammate, it doesn't matter if you're the star player as a senior or that freshman that is just coming in, you respect each other.
Absolutely.
You know, you have that respect. And when you start breeding that culture of respect, the sport itself becomes, you know, more enjoyable, not just, you know, for the kids themselves, but it becomes more for the fans, the coaches, just everything becomes easier when you inject that common respect that you have for everyone and just common, you know, good manners, things like that. Hey, they're on the ground, help them up.
Absolutely.
You know, you see that kid in practice who maybe hasn't gotten a drill right all week, and all of a sudden they're nailing. It's like, hey, man, good job.
Yeah.
Give that, you know, give that notoriety. But then on the flip side of that, also accountability.
Mm.
You know, you want to have the players, the coaches, the fans, everyone be accountable.
Now, if you enjoyed that conversation and would like to hear the rest of it, you can go and search for Hawk Talk HPS on Apple Podcasts, Spotify Podcasts, and of course, our YouTube channel. Now on to the rest of our broadcast.
Your Nighthawks girls basketball will be back in action shortly, but don't go anywhere. Stay tuned for an exciting lineup of content, including school news stories, streamer spotlight, Hawk Talk podcast previews, sports highlights, local announcements, and most importantly, special messages from our local sponsors who play a vital role in supporting this program.
The Hedinger Chamber of Commerce is a local business that supports other businesses in the Hedinger community. Their goal is to promote businesses and sponsor events in hope of attracting people to Hedinger while getting the community more involved. If you have questions about starting your business, an event, or want to find out more about the chamber, contact us at 701-567-2531 or visit us at 120 South Main Street.
Dakota Western Bank, your trusting partner since 1910, serving Hedinger, North Dakota, for personal banking with checking, savings, and auto loans for businesses in agriculture. We offer tailored services and digital solutions. Discover online banking applications and mobile options. Visit our website for locations, hours, and career opportunities. Dakota Western Bank, where banking meets community, proudly serving Hedinger, North Dakota.
Need a place to keep your cash safe and secure? Come on down to Dakota Plains Federal Credit Union. We can get you your cash fast with our drive-through, which is open from 8:30 a.m. to 4:30 p.m., or you could come into the lobby, which is open from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. We've been serving the community since 1992, and we are located at 221 South Main Street. You can contact us at 701-567-2153.
Take the next minute to learn about some upcoming reminders and events for Hedinger Public School and the Hedinger community.
West River has been serving our community for over 40 years. Our agents are here to help you get your home, auto, farm, ranch, business, health, and crop insurance. We are located in the lower level of Dakota Western Bank. Swing by at 603 Adams Avenue or call us at 701-567-9378.
The HBS Stream Team is a school-to-work program in which students in grades 7 through 12 gain real-world experience while learning about the basics of live broadcasting and providing a service to our community. Now, let us take a moment to meet one of our members who help us make this possible.
Hey, everybody. Thank you very much for tuning in again to the Streamer Spotlight. Today, I have sitting with me is Brennan Friebel. Brennan, hi. Thank you so much for coming in and talking with us today.
Yeah, it's nice to be with you too.
Awesome. So we're bringing in students. If you haven't seen the Streamer Spotlight before, we bring in students to talk about basically, you know, who they are, so you can meet who the streamers are behind the cameras, behind the laptops, behind the mics, so you can meet those students, learn a little bit about them, and that way, you know, it provides a little bit more value and a little bit more depth behind the stream team and all the kids behind it. So first off, so Brennan, let's learn about you as a student. So you're a student here at Hettinger Public School for part of the day, correct? What classes are you in?
Sixth and seventh period. Mm-hmm. Both of your classes, video production and graphic design, and I'm also in choir.
Yep, absolutely. And you've been a joy to have part of those classes. You joined us last year, right?
Yeah.
Yep.
Not in graphic design though.
No, this is your first year for graphic design.
Yeah.
And Brennan came in last year and actually was not the winner but the runner up for the film festival last year when we did the video production and created a great film. You can find it on the HPS Stream Team YouTube channel called Brennan's Quest for Milk. It is a wonderful short film. But yeah, so your thoughts on those classes?
Well, video production is really great. Mm-hmm. It's the first one, obviously, so I'm going to hold a lot of fond memories to it.
Of course.
Mm-hmm. And graphic design is also great, but if I were to make a tier list, it'd be a bit under video production.
That's okay. That's right. I need the honesty.
And then there's always that one class you kind of like, yay, I like this class, but also, oh, I don't really like this class. Yeah, that'd be choir.
Oh, that's all right, though, because it might challenge you a little bit, you know, and there's, you're still learning valuable skills in that class as well. And I've heard you sing, sound wonderful. You do a great job. So you provide value to that group as well. So that's wonderful. So another thing, too, that we'll kind of talk about is not only Brennan as a student, but also the stream team, Brennan's experience of the stream team, his impact and all that stuff. So, Brennan, why do you like the stream team? What is the things that you enjoy about it?
Well, because I get to get out a lot more. I don't
it pulls you out of the home. You got some stuff to do. Absolutely.
And it also lets me, you know, get to know other people who work with me and have similar interests.
Absolutely. So you can kind of make some friends. And if I'm correct, you worked with Dakota Hibbard, and he's a good friend of yours.
Yeah, we're actually like childhood friends.
Okay, so good point. So it gives you another reason to hang out and be with your friends and all that stuff. One of the fun things that we like to do with the Streamer Spotlight is also just to kind of tell fun stories or just to kind of bring fun highlights about our streamers.
Basically rescheduled due to the weather, and we're about ready to rock and roll here tonight. Early start, JV picked up a big win, their final JV game of the year. Nice job of them to pick up a win to wrap up the JV season. Looking at the varsity, this will be the last game before the district tournament coming up on Saturday. The girls will be in Glen Ullin, and they will be taking on possibly Belfield, unless something crazy happens in the next night or two. But I think it is the 4 seed, Hettinger Scranton, taking on number 5, Belfield, in the first round of the district tournament. We're just a couple seconds away from starting lineups tonight as the Nighthawks, as we said, coming in the 4 seed. They're going to have the national anthem first off, and then we'll have your starting lineups for tonight's action. It is Black Devil night tonight, so all the girls in their Black Devil uniforms. They did the Scranton last week. And now we are doing the Lady Devil Night here on this Tuesday evening. So stick close to KNDC 1490 AM, 106.7 FM, and HPS Stream Team for your starting lineups and your opening tip-off between the Region 3 rivals, the Garrison Troopers. So we'll pause for the national anthem, come back in 2 minutes with your starting lineups in just a bit. At 103 Highway 8 South in Hedinger, call 567-4380. It's Lakeside Auto Body and Glass of Hedinger. Law for Vermeer operates on the premise that parts and service support doesn't help tomorrow when you're in the field today. With Vermeer equipment, you're getting more than a machine. You're investing in quality parts, local service, and support from your local dealer. That's the part that matters. La for Vermeer provides quality parts and service. They're passionate about agriculture, especially when it comes to making high-quality hay for the nation's farmers and ranchers. And they understand you need quality parts to do so. Call La for Vermeer today in Hedinger, 567-4368. That's La for Vermeer, 567-4368. The Laundry Chute of Hedinger would like to congratulate and wish best of luck to all the athletes and coaches. The Laundry Chute is a 24/7 laundromat in Hedinger at 103 3rd Street South. They also have full service available by calling 701-928-0300. It's the Laundry Chute in Hedinger saying good luck, Nighthawks, this sports season. Shop local. Shop Lodgepole Store and Well Service of Lodgepole, South Dakota. Give Dick or Mary a call today at 605-564-2173 for all of your appliance needs. Need a new washer?
First, for the visitors on the scoreboard, the Garrison Trooper. Starting at one guard, the Troopers is a 5'10" sophomore, number 3, Kara Schlair. At a guard for the Troopers is a 5'4" eighth grader, number 5.
All right, welcome back here as the Nighthawks getting ready for the Garrison Troopers. Going to run down your starting lineups tonight. And they're going to go this way at the guards. Kara Sheeler coming in, a 5'10 sophomore. The other guard, a 5'4", eighth grader, number 5, Addison Engelhart. Forwards tonight, 5'6", freshman Sadie Majerus. The other forward, a 5'11", senior, number 13, Emily Schlair. And in the post tonight, coming in number 25, a 5'9" sophomore, Abigail Heinzen. Well, there are your starters for the Garrison Troopers. And now for your Hedinger Scranton Nighthawks. Shower coming in, a junior for the Hedinger Scranton Nighthawks.
Starting at a guard for the Black Devils, a 5'7" junior.
And another guard, a 5'7" junior. Number 10, going to be Layla Jensen. At a forward, a 5'7" junior. Number 14, Sophia Kennedy.
And another forward for the Black Devils, a 5'7" junior.
The next starters are going to be seniors, seeing their last starting action tonight. Two girls have put a lot of blood, sweat, and tears into this program.
Starting at a four for the Black Devils, a 5'7" senior, number 15, Gabby Dix.
At the forward position, number 15, Gabby Dix.
And at a four for the Black Devils, a 5'9"
senior, and at the post, going to come in, number 22, going to be Olivia Belka. for tonight. Eric Kellner, Nolan Dix, Jeremy Fordahl, your coaches. Throughout this year, it's been a fun year. The girls are playing some great basketball. We're looking forward to district tournament action here on KNDC. John Kohler will be up helping things out here next, or this coming Saturday, I should say, in Glen Ullin. So we are ready to go. Jumping center for Garrison will be Kara Schler, coming in a 5'10" sophomore. Welcome in up into the Garrison area. Sophia Kennedy will jump center, and it's going to be tip controlled by Garrison. So the Troopers having a pretty nice season. They're up in the top three over in that other district. They will see, we may see them in regionals. You never know. Nighthawks could be playing Central McLean, Washburn. There's a lot of good teams. Here comes a jump shot from the outside. Bucket up no good. Ball going to be tipped out of bounds. Last touch by the Troopers. Nice job. Nice boxing out by the Nighthawks. Of Elkin Dix underneath there. Bring the basketball, Layla Jensen. Going to go five out here for the Nighthawks. Jensen will have Kennedy to her left. We'll hand it off left wing. Jensen back out. Dix on the left side. Brings it up top of the key. Back to Velka. Bringing it right side to Schauer. Schauer off the screen. Left side. Now part Kennedy. Kennedy, top of the key. Left side. Schauer now looking to drive baseline. Gets cut off. Back out of Velka. Dix going to whip it around Jensen off the left side screen. Back Schauer, 8 seconds on the shot clock. Got to hurry, 5 seconds on the shot clock. Got to go. Underneath it go Jensen, little five-footer on the way. That's going to be up no good. Rebound going to be pulled down by the Troopers. 1 minute gone by here in this first quarter. Coming across right side into the corner. They go Schler. Schler cross court left side. Bringing it back around. 18-footer up no good. Rebound going to be pulled down by the Troopers. Back out comes Schler. Underneath the go shot on the way up. And a foul is going to be called. So 6:48 to go in this first quarter. Going to the free throw line will be Abigail Heinzen, a 5'9" sophomore. For two shots. First one going to be up no good. Dix and Avelka will come out. Morris and Ose will check back in. Second free throw on the way is going to come up off the back iron. Rebound going to be pulled down by Layla Jensen. So back across come the Nighthawks. Jensen across right side screen off the screen of Ose. Brings it around. Looking on the inside is Schauer. Can't find her out for Kennedy. Kennedy now to the corner. Jensen on the way for three. Got it. Layla Jensen hitting her first three. And a quick 3-0 lead here. Minute and a half into this first quarter. Bringing the basketball around left side will be Majerus. Majerus will cut through. A two-quarter B-squatter who starts varsity, I guess. Three-pointer on the way. That's going to be up no good. Rebound for Kelly Schauer. Schauer going to push it up that right sideline to Layla Jensen. Jensen on the right wing. Nice steal by Ose. Couldn't get it to her. Back it around Morris. Morris up top of the key. Jensen. Now Jensen hands it off. Schauer looking underneath for Ose. Just kind of hanging out in the 2-3 zone. Shot up no good. Rebound Ose. Ball on the floor and lost out of bounds by Garrison. It'll be Nighthawk basketball. Should say the Black Devil basketball. We're on a throwback night tonight. 5:42 to go here in the first quarter. 3-0 our score. They'll bring the basketball in. Schauer looking. Throws it away. First turnover on the Nighthawks. Coming across right side. Now Schauer going to get a little cheap foul. They bring it across half court stripe. So with 5:37 to go here in this first quarter. They'll bring the inbounds underneath us is Kara Schler. Schler now to the left side, works it around. She throws up a three, it's online, she got it. Schler hitting her first three. Schler coming in a sophomore for Garrison. Back across comes Jensen in a 3-3 ball game. 5:20 to go, first quarter. Jensen off the left side screen of Morris. Morris going to penetrate left side into the corner. Now finds Schauer. Top of the key, Jensen. Jensen into the lane, goes in left-handed off the backboard, up and good. Nice shot by Layla Jensen. 5-3 the score. Santa Berwick will get ready to check in. Cross court left side, they're working around for Iglehart. Now to the left side, checking in was Tennille Kahlberg, a freshman for Garrison. Working around Schlaer. Now to the free throw line, 15-footer from Schlaer. Emily Schlaer is up, no good. Rebound going to be pulled down by Schauer. And it will be, well, it's going to be Trooper basketball. Schauer had it corralled. Kenley Stodheim will check into the ballgame as well for Schauer. Morris will come out for Berwick. Kara Schlaer will inbounds, a sophomore. They'll bring the inbounds left side. On the left wing, penetrating is Addison Egelhart, and now a foul is going to be called. They're going to get Kinley Stodheim with her first personal third team foul here in the first 3 minutes and 15 seconds. Four's on the board, 4 minutes, 44 seconds inside. Shot going to be partially blocked. Coming down with it is Abigail Heinzen, who went 0 for 2 from the free throw line. She now penetrates. Ball going to be tipped away, but picked back up right side by Schlaer. Schlaer into the paint. Ball tipped, lost by Garrison. Should be Black Devil basketball, and it is. Gives the basketball back here to the Nighthawks. 4:31 to go, first quarter. Now bring it across is Jensen. Jensen across the time stripe, stops free throw line, backs it around left side, Berwick. Out for Stodheim, into the quarter, ball tipped and last touched by Garrison. It'll stay with the Black Devils with 4:20 to go here in the first quarter of action on this regional matchup. Once again, they're in the opposite district. We will see them be playing in the first round of the districts this Saturday in Glen Ullin. They'll be in the other district. My fault. We'll be in the regional tournament. Garrison should make that regional tournament along with the Nighthawks. So Jensen with the basketball. Five of the first five here for Jensen. She'll dribble it around. Quick penetration. Left side three. Berwick off the back iron. Rebound going to be pulled down in the corner by Vanessa Ose. Nice job by Ose. Hands it to Kennedy. Can't hold on to it. Ball stripped away. Ooh. Loose basketball going to come away now for Schlaer. And here comes Garrison running the floor. Whips it right side. Heinzen from 15 is good. Abigail Heinzen making it 5-5. Coming across will be Kinley Stodheim. Nice move on the inside. Five-footer off the board is up and good for Kinley Stodheim. Picking up her first bucket. 7-5 Nighthawks. Into the corner now is Schlaer. Schlaer in the right wing. Nighthawks at a 2-3 zone. Working around, three from Kara Schlaer is off the mark. Rebound going to be pulled down weak side by Egelhart. Backs it around for Emily Schlaer. Into the paint, little five-foot floater on the way is up and good for Kara Schlaer. 5 points for Kara, 7-7 our score, 3:10 to go here in the first quarter. An official time here. One of the girls has bloody nose. So she will come out. Monica Morris will check in for Kennedy. At the 3:07 mark. Looking around for anything on the floor. So a 3:07 to go here in the first quarter. A 7-7 ball game. Hettinger Scranton and the Garrison Troopers squaring off here in a good matchup. Haven't played Garrison in a long time. Look around Monica Morris. Morris looking for Jensen underneath. Had her posted up. Couldn't get it. Nope. Want to force it. And they overthrow Jensen. Jensen comes away with it. Ball loose. And a jump ball will be called. Possession arrow stays with the Black Devils with 2:48 to go. First quarter action. Once again, an early start due to the fact that Garrison in central time zone and 3 hours away. JV won. They started at 3:30. This one a little bit later of a start. So at the 2:46 mark, Garrison gets the basketball back. Coming across now will be Kara Schlaer. Schlaer to the right side. Double teamed over on that right wing. Backs around for Sadie Majerus. Back out another three attempt on the way. That's off the mark. Rebound Layla Jensen. So Jensen now going to push it up the floor. She whips it right side for Stodheim. Stodheim into the lane, gets her pocket picked. And a foul is going to be called. They're going to get Schlaer. take the basketball. That's going to be the second team foul. First team foul on Kara Schlaer. Inbounding left baseline will be Layla Jensen. Jensen on the left side finds Ose underneath, spins back inside. 5-footers up and good. Vanessa Ose scoring her first bucket. 9-7 the score. 2:16 to go in the first. Coming back across right side will be Schlaer. Left side, Majerus. Into the corner they work it. A two-point lead for the Black Devils and a steal by Berwick. It was tipped by Stadheim. Quickly back the other way come the Black Devils. Right side, Morris. Morris into the paint, kicks it out, Berwick. Looks at three. Instead, Morris going to pull the trigger. Got it. Monica Morris hitting her first three. And the Night Hawks now lead it 12-7. We'll go back and forth between the Night Hawks and the Black Devils all night, I'm sure. Jump shot on the way from Heinzen is no good. Rebound, Kinley Stadheim. Stadheim going to hold the basketball, hand it back for Ose. And a foul is going to be called. So with a minute 39 to go, first quarter, 5-point lead for Hettinger Scranton. Coming across will be Vogt. Going to lose the handle on it, stolen away. Addison Egelhart will go length of the court, lays it up high up the glass, bucket good. Addison Egelhart picking up her first bucket. Second turnover on the Black Devils as Monica Morris will bring it across right side, leading it by three. Minute 20 to go here in the quarter. Stadheim with the basketball. They have Ose if they wanted her, but can't get it to her. Works around Stadheim. Stadheim into the lane. She's uncontested and a foul before the shot. So back to the right baseline will be Layla Jensen. We'll bring it in for Ose. Ose looking for a post up. They have her. Sealed out right side back for Jensen. Jensen beyond the 3-point stripe. Pulls the trigger on a three. That's going to be no good. Rebound Monica Morris. Morris will hand it back for Berwick. Got to dribble her way out. Back for Stadheim. Down to under a minute now to go. We'll hand it back for Layla. Quick right side, Morris, bounce pass into the corner. Jensen steps behind three, no good. And the rebound going to be pulled down by Tennille Kahlberg. Kahlberg going to bring it back. Quick pass underneath. What a pass underneath. Shot up, no good. Nice pass by Schlaer, missed by Heinzen. And back comes Jensen and the Black Devils. Left side, Berwick. Berwick thought about the three. Handed back now for Jensen. Jensen inside the paint, 5-4. That's no good. Rebound, Ose. She'll go up hard left-handed. That's no good. Rebound going to be pulled down by Emily Schlaer. So Schlaer will bring it back right side for Heinzen. Heinzen will lose the basketball. Work it back around. Egelhart down to 13 seconds now. Ball be tipped and lost out of bounds by Garrison. Turnover number two now on the Garrison Troopers. Checking back in will be Sadie Majerus, a freshman. So we're down to 9.7 seconds. Bring it across left side. It'll be Berwick off the screen right side. Morris going to look at three. Let's her fly by. No good. And that will end our first quarter at the end of 8 minutes. 12-9. Nighthawks lead it by three. We're back in 1 minute. Hodgepole can get it for you. They carry a variety of Crosley appliances on hand, or you can order in other name brand appliances. Lodgepole Store can also service your windmills, submersible pumps, or pressure systems. Give Lodgepole Store and Well Service a call today, 605-564-2713. That's Lodgepole Store and Well Service of Lodgepole.
You want to feel important. You want to be a part of something bigger, something that matters and can help change things. You want to feel like you belong. We know. We felt that way too. And that's why we did something about it. We aren't just Army National Guard soldiers. We are normal people just like you. And together, we can make a difference. Take on your legacy. Visit NationalGuard.com to find out more.
Sponsored by the North Dakota Army National Guard. Aired by the North Dakota Broadcasters Association and this station. I checked with dealers in Nebraska, maybe three or four in South Dakota, and a couple up north, and Monty Linscove and the team at Premier Equipment really came through. They consistently beat the competition by a substantial margin on their pricing.
Contact your local Premier Equipment dealer or see their all-star new Holland lineup at PremierEQSD.com. Locations at Isabel, Battle, Mobridge, Huron, and Eureka. Linscove family-owned Premier Equipment, serving farmers and ranchers since 1951.
All right, welcome back here. Just starting the second quarter, three-pointer away from Garris. Going to be no good. Rebound, Kinley Stadheim. Stadheim going to push her way up, lose the basketball, now picks it up. Nowhere to go. It has to give it off. Right side, Shower. Shower now to the right side. Back Stadheim, and they're going to get her on a travel. Turnover number three. Third turnover tonight. We'll give the basketball back to Garrison. And now steal by Stadheim. Stadheim up ahead of everybody, lays it up off the glass, bucket good. Kinley Stadheim with four. And it's 14-9, a five-point lead now for the Nighthawks. They're working around right side of the baseline of the goal. Almost threw it out of bounds, but coming away with it is Schlaer, Emily Schlaer up top of the key. Back left wing now, Majerus. Majerus will cut through. They're looking for Heinzen inside. Back into the corner. Skip pass for Kara Schlaer, drops it inside, and a foul's going to be called on Havelka. So 1 minute gone by here in the quarter. They'll inbounds left baseline with Kara Schlaer. She brings it in, looking to post up. She gets it inside, little hook shot from five is no good. Rebound going to be pulled down by Schauer. So Schauer will hand it off for Berwick. 6:50 to go. Bring it across left side will be Kelly Schauer. And no body contact there, so they're going to say over Mac. Turnover number four. And we'll give the basketball back to the Troopers here with a five-point lead for the Black Devils tonight in throwback night. We did the Scranton throwback. The boys did the Hettinger one last night. Won in overtime, 63-62, and a big district win for them. Almost stolen away by Schauer. They'll bring it back around left side is Schlaer. Schlaer on the left wing. Bounce pass up top of the key. Find it for Egelhart. Egelhart one-on-one to the right side. Nice job by Berwick defensively. Brings it up top of the key. Underneath it, a nice pass underneath. Ball scoops it up, no good, and a foul's going to be called. They're going to get Morris, I believe, on her first. The 6:17 mark. First free throw on the way is up and good. Emily Schlaer making it 14-10. Stadheim will sit out. Jensen back in. Kennedy in. Ose out. And Berwick out. Free throw up. No good. Rebound. Pulled down by Schlaer. Goes up. Left-handed layup. Bucket good. Kara Schlaer now with seven. And it's 14-12. They'll bring it now. Jump shot from the corner is going to be no good for Schauer. Rebound going to be pulled out by Majerus. They'll bring the basketball around. Three-pointer up going to be no good. Rebound saved in. Oh, Kennedy couldn't pull it in. So with 5:47 to go. They will bring the inbounds left baseline now for Kara Schlaer. Inside the paint, five-footer no good. She's going to be fouled. Fouled by Ose. That'll be the first personal for Ose. And third team foul here in the quarter. Coming back now will be Abigail Heinzen, a sophomore. Free throw up no good. Heinzen now 0 of 3 from the free throw line. 5:46 to go. Free throw up. No good. Rebound going to be pulled down by Monica Morris. They'll bring the basketball around. Lanox will have it. Underneath Morris, five-footer, score it, and she's fouled. Monica Morris, 5 points. And a free throw coming. So free throw coming here for Morris. Free throw going to be no good. Here come the troopers back the other way. Three-pointer is good. Addison Engelhart, she now has five. Coming across now will be the Nighthawks. Will be Jensen. Jensen, now they're going to throw it away. Six turnovers now. Quick pass up left side. Working around Majerus. Drops the three out for Ehlert. Nope, no good. Rebound going to be pulled down by Kennedy. So hand it off for Jensen. And a timeout on the floor with 5 minutes to go. Second quarter, 16-15. Nighthawks by one. We're back in 60.
Construction equipment dealers. Red Rock Ford in Williston and Dickinson wants you to know this is the very best time to park a brand new F-150 in your driveway. Red Rock Ford in Williston and Dickinson has a great lineup of F-150 XLTs ready for immediate delivery.
Here's the great news. Take advantage of low, low 3.9% financing, plus take up to $10,000 right off the top. Yes, you heard right. Low 3.9% plus $10,000 off MSRP.
And here's more great news. Take advantage of 0% financing on 23 Ford Edge. Special deals on more Ford SUVs, too. Choose a Ford Escape or the popular Bronco Sport and get low 2.9% financing, plus $3,000 off MSRP.
Red Rock has a great selection. Choose your F-150 or favorite SUV and get great low financing paired with some of the biggest discounts we've seen for a long time.
It's time for a test drive and the very best buy at Red Rock Ford in Williston and Dickinson.
Scranton Equity Agronomy is a major retailer of... All right, welcome back here on this Tuesday night. 5 minutes remaining. Your Nighthawks had to call the timeout. Leading it still by one here, but Ford had some big turnovers, and there's another one. Going to be turnover number seven underneath, and a foul hard on Kennedy. So Sophia Kennedy will pick up the foul. Nope, they're going to get Jensen on the foul. Thought they were going to get Kennedy on that one. They will get Jensen. 4:49 to go here in the quarter. Second quarter action from Hettinger on John Butterfield Court. Free throw up is no good. This is Addison Engelhart. This will be her first trip to the free throw line. 0-for-1. Second free throw coming. Second shot is good. 16's on the board, 4:49 to go, first half. Tie ball game. Nighthawks had a 6-point lead, now 7-point lead, actually. And now it's whittled down to nothing underneath the goal. Havelka now throws it in the traffic, throws it away. Turnover number 8. And back across come the troopers with 4.5 to go here in the first half. 16's on the board, coming across right side. They're going to hand it off now to Isabel Rhyme, who's checked into the ball game. Rhyme, left side, Engelhart. Now to the free throw line. Kara Schlaer inside the paint, and a foul is going to be called on Havelka. So two more free throws coming here for the Troopers. Abigail Heinzen. Heinzen tonight 0-4 from the free throw line. As Heinzen will have one more, or two actually, excuse me. First one on the way is going to be good. 17-16. Second one on the way, also good. 18-16. Nighthawks down by two here into the corner. They go Berwick. Berwick sails it right side, backs it around for Jensen. Jensen now going to avoid the double team into the corner. Morris going to try a three, no good. Rebound going to be pulled down by the Troopers, number 5. That is Addison Engelhart. Engelhart across the time stripe. We're halfway through the second quarter. Bounce pass left side, Heinzen from 15, no good. And the Troopers come up with it inside the paint, off the backboard, bucket good. That is Kara Schlaer. She now has 9, and it's 20-16. Into the corner, Burrick. Burrick back, Jensen. Jensen and Burrick will play catch, skip pass right side, Morris. To the bounce pass, Stoddheim. Stoddheim going to try a 3. That's no good. Rebound, Ose comes away with it. Kicks it back out, Burrick. She'll go inside, left-handed layup. Oh, bucket good. Santa Burrick scoring her first bucket, 20-18. Now Nighthawks down 2 with 3:19 remaining. Cross court left side, they'll work it now for Heinzen. Left side 3 is Isabel Reim. She hits it. Isabel Reim, a sophomore, very young squad here. One senior, that is Emily Schlaer. Everybody else, one junior, the rest sophomores, freshmen, and eighth graders. Morris going to drive right baseline, makes the bucket. 7 points for Monica Morris. 23-20 now, Garrison by 3. Back across comes Kara Schlaer. Schlaer, top of the key, right side is Egelhart. Egelhart into the paint, ball going to be tipped, and a foul is going to be called on. They're going to get Jensen, that's going to be her second. So with 2:44 to go, more free throws coming here for the Troopers. Addison Egelhart, 1 of 2 from the free throw line. First of 2 on the way is up and good. 2 of 3 now. 7 points for Addison Egelhart. She'll have one more. Egelhart sets, free throw up, good. All right, Troopers making their free throws down the stretch here in the third quarter, 25-20. Across they come, Jensen. Jensen, quick pass out, Morris. Morris in the lane, back out Burrick. Burrick and Jensen. Good defense by the Troopers. They're just swarming all over the place, preventing any shots. Now a jump shot before the shot, they're going to say. And they're going to get Sadie Majerus, I guess. I didn't think Sadie was even close. So with 2:28 to go, Nighthawks have the basketball, and now Ose will throw it away underneath. Turnover number 10 now on the Nighthawks. Back the other way come the Troopers. And now a double dribble or a carry, and that's carry's going to be called. Going to be turnover number 4 only on the Troopers at the 2:19 mark. Coming across will be Layla Jensen. Jensen across the time stripe, left side. They'll work corner right side. Into the lane, Stoddheim from 5. That's no good. Rebound going to be pulled down. So quickly back come the Troopers. 1:56 to go. Oh, a big 3 in the corner by Isabel Reim. She has 6. And now the Nighthawks will throw it away. So we'll give the basketball back here. So coming back the other way will be the Troopers, and now a timeout's going to be called. 1:38 to go, second quarter. Garrison leading it by 8 now, 28-20. We'll take a break on KNDC Hettinger and HPS Stream Team back in 30.
Southwest North Dakota and Northwest South Dakota. Their experienced team works hard to keep up with the latest in agronomic technology and production. Their licensed applicators are well trained and can custom apply fertilizers or chemical products. Scranton Equity's agronomy team is proud to offer the following products and services: fertilizer and fertilizer blending, crop protection and chemicals, customer application and soil testing. That's Scranton Equity Agronomy. Call 701-275-8103. Proud sponsors of Nighthawk Sports. Need help transporting your kids during the school year? Southwest Public Transit can help.
All right, welcome back here. Minute 38 to go. Garrison now up to an 8-point lead here. Has the basketball after the timeout. Quick pass underneath, and Ose going to get called on the foul. And more free throws coming now for Garrison. Abigail Heinzen, 2 for 6 now is Heinzen. And she'll have two free throws. Going to be the second personal on Ose. Havelka will check in. Free throw on the way is up and good. 29-20. Minute 33 to go here in the half. Second free throw coming. Is Heinzen. Free throw up, free throw good. So the Troopers, credit them. They've been making their free throws, and they have gotten up to a 10-point lead here with a minute 29 to go here in the quarter. Out of District 6, Night Hawks in District 5. They drop it underneath for Havelka, and then she gets called on a travel. Turnover number 11 will get the basketball back here to the Troopers with a minute 20 to go here in the half. So a 10-point lead for Garrison. Kara Schlerer with the basketball up top of the key. Addison Engelhardt. Engelhardt going to bounce it on the inside. Left-handed hook shot up, no good. Rebound going to be coming down now. Foul's going to be called on Havelka. Just kind of standing there and gets called on the with the knee. So down to 105, and we're going to see more free throws from Addison Engelhardt. So we're down to a minute 5. 30-20. Free throw up, no good. First free throw missed in a while for Garrison. They've built up a 10-point lead through free throws. They have 8 free throws here in the half. Majority of them coming here in the second quarter. Free throw up, no good. Rebound Layla Jensen. So down to a minute 4 now to go. Jensen across the time stripe, trailing it by 10. Berwick to the baseline. And another dangerous pass gets thrown away. Turnover number 12. Back come the Troopers. Quick pass on. Now they'll throw it away. Turnover number 5 on Garrison. So down to 51 seconds. At the half, we'll take an extended break here. Stay tuned to HPS Stream Team. But we'll take a break on KNDC with some sponsors. Jensen going to drive in. 5-foot floater up, no good. Rebound, lost out of bounds. Last touch by the Troopers with 41 seconds to go. So Morris and Kennedy will check in for Stadheim and Havelka. With 41 seconds remaining. Shower will bring it in left side. Top of the key. Work it left side, Berwick. Berwick into the paint. Quick pass out right side. Monica Morris for 3. That's no good. And the shooting woes continue for the Night Hawks here as Kara Schlerer brings it down the other end of the basketball court. Right side 3. Emily Schlerer is up no good. Rebound deep left side. Weak side is Engelhardt. And she'll lose the handle. It falls down. Now it's going to be stolen away by Morris. And here comes Shower. 15 seconds to go in the half. Comes Jensen. Jensen, length of the court, lays it up off the glass. That's no good. So with 9 seconds to go, back comes Heinzen. Heinzen across the time stripe. Ball tipped, right side 3, no good. And that will end our first half. 16 minutes into the books. Garrison leads it 30-20 after 16 minutes of basketball. We'll take about an 8-minute break here on KNDC Hettinger. Stay tuned to HPS Stream Team. Stick around on Black Devil Night. And we'll bring you more basketball action here on KNDC Hettinger in just a bit, so stick close. We'll take a break, be back during our halftime show. Garrison leads it 30-20 over the Hettinger Scranton Black Devils.
Has truly become kind of the neutral, chaotic energy. If you know Brennan, you know what I'm talking about. He's a very random individual, but it's very fun. As long as we can, you know, hold in the reins, it can be a very, very fun and entertaining experience being around Brennan. You don't really know what he's going to say, what's going to come out of his mouth, but it is never boring, that's for sure. And again, going back to his short film, if you watch that, you'll understand the creativity and randomness that he has. But I just want to say, Brennan, thank you very, very much for being on the stream team and being a part of the program and also part of the classes and all of that. So thank you very much. All right.
Waffle.
Bye-bye.
Your Nighthawks girls basketball will be back in action shortly. But don't go anywhere. Stay tuned for an exciting lineup of content, including school news stories, streamer spotlight, Hawk Talk podcast previews, sports highlights, local announcements, and most importantly, special messages from our local sponsors who play a vital role in supporting this program.
At Ag Pro Machine, we provide quality work and full-time service for ag and automotive equipment. We also have a large selection of parts and tools for your automotive and ag equipment. Call at 701-567-7500. Or you can also stop by east of Henniger along Highway 12.
Graphic Addict specializes in embroidery, screen printing, direct-to-garment printing, along with expert video and audio digitalization.
All right, welcome back here at halftime. The Garrison Troopers leading it here by a score of 30-20, leading scores for the Nighthawks. Leading the way, Monica Morris with 7. 5 points for Layla Jensen, 2 for Sienna Berwick, 4 for Kinley Stodheim, 2 for Vanessa Ose. Nighthawks turned the basketball over 12 times in the first half. For the Garrison Troopers, 9 points for Kara Schlaer, 8 points for Addison Engelhardt, 6 points for Isabel Rimes, 6 for Abigail Heinzen, and 1 for Emily Schlaer. Troopers did turn the basketball over just 5 times in the first half. They controlled the basketball game in the first half. Got down early, but got back with, as we said, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 free throws to take the lead and keep the lead. They're up 10 here at the half. Once again, our halftime score, the Nighthawks, or we'll say tonight in throwback night, the Black Devils trail it here to the Garrison Troopers, 30-20. Stick close to KNDC 1490 AM, 106.7 FM. We'll be back with third quarter action in just a bit on KNDC Hettinger and HPS Stream Team.
Flavors of delight with jelly beans when you visit. Don't miss out on gearing up for the upcoming sports seasons with our exclusive Nighthawk collection. Drop by Graphic Attic or call us at 567-3161 to discover the perfect fit for your style and needs.
Here at Kennedy's, we provide fresh goods and groceries for all your daily needs, ranging from our special selection of fruits and vegetables to our specially created delis and bakeries. Find us on 200 North Main Street or call us at 701-567-2404 to place an order.
Big deal with that subscribe button. It's not just for following our YouTube channel, it signifies much more. When you subscribe, you become a part of the HPS Stream Team, proudly supporting our vibrant program led by our students. Your subscription is a powerful statement, creating a positive ripple effect across our community and beyond. And don't forget, liking this video also sends a clear message to the students working this broadcast. It's a way to appreciate their hard work and motivates them to produce high-quality broadcasts. So, go ahead, show your support, like this video, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thanks for watching!
Welcome to West River Vet Clinic. Here, we aren't just your pet's healthcare provider, we're their second family. Our awesome vets offer everything from checkups to surgery. Plus, we've got great grooming. Here, we are big on preventative care to keep your furry friends happy and healthy. We also ensure a stress-free environment for both pets and their owners. For our services, you can visit westrivervet.com. You can find us at 203 US Highway 12 East or call us at 701-567-4333.
Your Nighthawks girls basketball will be back in action shortly, but don't go anywhere. Stay tuned for an exciting lineup of content, including school news stories, streamer spotlight, Hawk Talk podcast previews, sports highlights, local announcements, and most importantly, special messages from our local sponsors who play a vital role in supporting this program.
Grand River Honey is a family-run business that's been making honey in both North and South Dakota and selling it to customers for over 30 years. We make several pounds of honey seasonally, all 100% raw and natural. This includes both clover and creamed honey. If you want some honey, call 701-567-3439, go to dakotahoney.com, or take a right after the railroad tracks on Country Club Road, Hettinger, North Dakota, 58639.
Here at The Gutter, we provide a variety of food and entertainment. Make sure to enjoy bowling, pool, VR, table tennis, air hockey, and much more while we prepare your order. We have pizza, burgers, fries, dessert, drinks, and much more. You can find us by taking a left at the end of Main Street or call us at 701-567-6749.
KB Jewelers is not only a jewelry store, but they also contain a lot of other great things such as trophies, books, holiday decor, and more. When you're looking for gifts for family, friends, or if you want to look at some cool things, come on down. They're located on 206 South Main Street, Hettinger, North Dakota. You can contact them on their number 701-567-2358. They're open from 9 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. from Monday to Saturday each week. Come visit.
Welcome to the Peacock Mercantile.
We have been serving you since 2018. You can get baked goods like cookies, muffins, and pies. You can also get caffeinated beverages and non-caffeinated beverages. The Peacock is a nice place to socialize and meet new people. The Peacock also has refreshments like hot and cold coffee and smoothies. We are located at 213 South, Hettinger, North Dakota, 58639. You can reach us at 701-637-0102. Again, that was 701-637-0102.
The HPS Upload is a weekly broadcast of school news put on by the 7 through 12 video production class that provides coverage of recent events, sports, weather, and news stories. Now, let's take a look at the story from this week.
Last month, our high school students embarked on a new venture known as Lunch with the Hawks, a program designed to foster connections as they join elementary students for lunch. In an exclusive interview with both the high school participants and Ms. Olson, I learned more about how the program is developing.
I enjoyed it quite a bit, build connections with the younger students and hear what's all going on in the elementary. It's kind of fun. I visited with them about sports and what they like to do or what they did over the weekend or something like that, but just to make connections with them. I enjoyed it, yeah.
I thought it was fun to kind of see how like the dynamics of the lunchroom have changed but are also the same as when we were like that age, and just to like have a reminder of what it was like to be in like elementary.
Yeah, it was super fun being able to catch up with all the kids and hear their stories. It was super fun. After we were done eating and I was getting ready to leave, all the kids came up and gave a big hug and were like, bye, Miss Olivia. So it was super sweet to see that they enjoyed it.
I guess I thought it was a good thing.
For his landmark personal achievement this past weekend, Nolan Dix, who is our assistant coach and the voice of Nighthawks across the state, was inducted into the North Dakota Sportscasters Sports Broadcasters Hall of Fame this year. The Miners and the Nighthawks since 1999.
got to get on the air. All right, welcome back. We're getting a thumbs up from the official, and we are ready to go. Third quarter action on this Tuesday night. That'll bring the basketball. Nighthawks down 10 here, so we got to get rolling to the Nighthawks. And now a reach-in foul is going to be called. That's going to go on Sadie Majerus. So Majerus picks up the foul. That's going to be her second first personal on the Troopers. Kelly Schauer brings the inbounds. She works it right side, Monica Morris. Morris back up, backs it around left side, Kennedy. Oh, doing a nice job posting up in there. Now travel's going to be called on Jensen. Turnover number 13 on the Nighthawks. Nighthawks going to jump into a press here. They're going to pick him up three-quarter court here. As Kara Schlaer brings it across the time stripe left side. They'll work it right side. Now for Kara Schlaer. Schlaer on the left side. Cross court right side. Looking at Egelhart for three. That's going to be no good, but gets her own. Nobody boxed out. Gets her own rebound. Kicks it back out for Kara Schlaer. She'll go baseline running one-hander. That's no good. Rebound, Monica Morris. So Morris going to bring it across the time stripe right side. Land it off for Layla Jensen. Jensen up near half court. 1 minute gone by here in the third quarter. Nobody has scored here. Still a 10-point ball game. And now they throw it away again. The Nighthawks will turn it over for the 14th time and almost a steal by Schauer. And coming across right side will be Emily Schlaer. Now to the right wing. Finds it out for Egelhart. Now to the left wing is Kara Schlaer. Bringing it back now will be Kara on the left side. She scored 9 points here so far in this ballgame. Very good shooter, a sophomore. All their big scorers are sophomores and freshmen, and now a foul's going to be called. That's going to go on Ose. And going back to the free throw line will be Addison Egelhart. And that'll be Vanessa's third personal. To the free throw line goes Egelhart. 3 of 6 from the free throw line. Make it 4 of 7. 31-20 our score. They'll bring the basketball to Addison Egelhart. Back for one more free throw. Free throw up, free throw good. 10 points for Egelhart, 32-20. Right side will be Jensen, cross court, Morris, skip pass, brings it back now for Kennedy. Dangerous pass going to be thrown out of bounds. It'll be tipped by Garrison at the 6-10 mark here in the third. Nighthawks just struggling to score the basketball here. They're working around Jensen. Jensen into the paint. Jump shot on the way, going to be no good. And a foul. So two shots coming for Layla Jensen. 5 points for Jensen. 32-20. That's our score. Nighthawks need to put some free throws on the board. And the first of two on the way is up and good. Layla Jensen now with 6, 32-21. One more free throw coming. Jensen steps up. Second one also good. Stadtheim and Berwick will check in. Schauer and Kennedy will sit down. With 6 minutes remaining in this third quarter, a 10-point lead. Coming across left side will be Schlaer. Schlaer now to the right side, brings it around for Emily Schlaer. Now reach-in foul is going to be called on Berwick. So Berwick picks up her second personal. No, that's going to be her first. Inbounding right side will be Kara Schlaer. Schlaer looking, brings it in, top of the key, Heinzen. Backs it around, Egelhart. Egelhart now to the left side, into the corner, Kara Schlaer for three, that's no good. Oh, it's going to be a push from behind as Berwick did a nice job of boxing out, but the foul's going to be called on Addison Egelhart. And we'll give the basketball back to the Nighthawks. Both teams have scored 2 points here in the half, 32-22. Back across comes Layla Jensen. Jensen, cross court it goes, Burrick. Burrick going to penetrate left side. Now to the left side baseline will be Morris. Morris gets the pass kicked back to her. She goes up from five. That's no good. Rebound going to be pulled down by Egelhart. Egelhart going to freeze up right side. Up comes Kara Schler. Schler going to, oh, they're not even going to pick her up. Whoa, nobody even stopped her on the way to the basket. Ose with the rebound will tip it right to the hands of Layla Jensen. Jensen across the time stripe, right side. Ball tipped in the air and tipped out again by Garrison. So it'll stay with the Nighthawks here at the 5:08 mark. So 5 minutes remaining here in the third. Nighthawks need a bucket. Ball tipped out of bounds again. I'll bring the inbounds, Monica Morris, just in front of us here. Brings it in for Jensen. A spread out zone defense here are the Garrison Troopers. Bring around Jensen, ball tipped out, and now a foul is going to be called. Who are they going to get? Foul's going to be called on Kara Schler. Maybe is her third. That's a big one for them. Three-pointer in the corner. Going to roll off. No good by Layla. Layla going to bring it up. Left side, Monica Morris into the paint. Five-footer is good. Monica Morris now with 9:24 now for the Nighthawks. 32 for the Troopers. Back to an eight-point ball game. Troopers going to bring it across for Kara Schler. Now to the left wing. Going to keep her in with three fouls. Back right wing now to the baseline, Egelhart. Works it around for Emily Schler. They'll get it up underneath. Left side three. Majerus good. Sadie Majerus with her first three. 35-24, up to an 11-point lead here. Biggest lead of the night here for Garrison. Will stay on the tip-off. Going to stay with the Nighthawks. So halfway through this third quarter, 35-24 our score. I'll bring the basketball in. Layla Jensen now to the left side. Burrick. Burrick finds Ose. Back out Jensen. She pulled the trigger on a three. That's going to be up no good. Rebound. Ose, five-footer is good. Vanessa Ose with her fourth point. It's now 35-26. Here comes Kara Schler. Ball loose on the floor. Picked back up right side for Heinzen. Back out Emily Schler. Kara comes back out, picks the basketball up. 9-point ball game. Garrison with the lead. 3:35 to go here in the third. Back it around left wing. Bounce pass can go. Majerus. Travel is going to be called. Turnover number 7 on Garrison. At the 3.5-minute mark, third quarter from Robert Trinke Auditorium. John Butterfield Court here on this Tuesday evening. Final regular season of the game for both these two teams. Garrison will be in districts on Friday, and now Stoddheim going to travel with it. Nighthawks will be in districts against Belfield on Saturday. We will let you know the upcoming games for this weekend for the girls. As we said, Friday is a bunch of games coming up. And now a steal. Turnover number 8, Burrick with the basketball. Bounce pass left side, Morris. Morris, top of the key, Jensen. Jensen now will back it out beyond the three-point stripe. Works it around. Back for Jensen. Jensen into the paint. 7-foot floater on the way is good. Layla Jensen scoring another two. 9 points for Layla. 35-28. Cuts it to 7. Now a steal by Jensen. Jensen one-on-one left side. Lays it up off the backboard. No good. Rebound going to be pulled down. Here come the Troopers back down the other way. Quick pass right side. Schler going to be no but Kara Schler. Now foul's going to be called. On Stoddheim, I think they're going to get. Central McLean will be taking on White Shield in the first round of their district. Some other games in that district will be Mandaree and Wilton Wing. And the tournament's going to be in Garrison. The number 10 Washburn will take on Center Stanton. final game of the night will be Garrison and New Salem Almont. Garrison coming in 13-5. Now the Troopers will now turn it over for their ninth turnover of the night. 2.5 remaining in the third quarter. A 7-point ball game. Layla bringing it across the time stripe. Now to the right wing, finds it out, Stoddheim. Stoddheim penetrates into the paint, little 7-foot floater. That is good. Kinley Stoddheim with 6, 35-30. And tipped out of bounds by Kinley. Nice job defensively here. 5-point ball game right now. 2:20 to go here in the third quarter. Don't want to rush this. It's going to be a good fourth quarter coming up. Oh, double dribble is going to be called. District 5 tournament not set yet. It'll be finalized tomorrow. As I believe there are a couple games still going tonight. Grand County is taking on Glen Ullin Hebron. New England and Southart playing. Games that could make a difference in the standings, but a timeout on the floor as it's 35-30. 2:16 to go in the third quarter. A quick 30-second timeout on KNDC and HPS Stream Team back in 30. Pick them up after school. Southwest Transit also makes trips to Sturgis, Spearfish, Bismarck, Rapid City, Dickinson, Richardson, and any other destination you need to go. Call Southwest Public Transit today at 567-2476 or toll-free 800-280-0204. Southwest Public Transit is here for all of your transportation needs for grocery trips or medical appointments. You can count on Southwest Public Transit, 567-2476. The Gutter of Hettinger is a proud Nighthawk sports sponsor here on KNDC Hettinger. The Gutter is open Wednesday and Thursdays, 4 to 8 p.m., Friday from 4 to 11, 11 a.m. to 11 p.m. on Saturday, and 11 a.m. to 8 p.m. on Sunday. You can give them a call at 567-6749. On Thursday, we'll let you know those tomorrow, and then the first round of the district tournament will be starting on Saturday in Glen Ullin. Two semifinals and two loser out ball games on Monday, and then we'll have the championship and two region qualifiers on Tuesday for the girls' district tournament. To the bounce pass they go, and now they're going to throw it away, taken away by the Troopers, Abigail Heinzen. Heinzen going to hand it back for Kara Schlaer. Schlaer now to the right side, works it around the perimeter. Going right baseline is Majerus. Ball tipped in the air, and a foul is going to be called. No, they're going to call her out of bounds. Turnover number 10 now on the Troopers. Nighthawks can get a little bit closer here. They've trailed by 10, 30-20 at the half. They've outscored right now 10-5. A little jumper on the way is up, no good by Jensen. Rebound going to be Kara Schlaer walking the tightrope. Going to be saved in, right to the hands. They're going to say out of bounds on the Nighthawks. We've got to get a louder whistle for the new official. Doesn't have the Fox 40. They bring the inbounds now for Abigail Heinzen. Heinzen finds Schlaer. Kara Schlaer brings it across the time stripe. Heinzen going to bring it down in the corner left side for Engelhardt. Now a long three. Emily Schlaer no good. Rebound going to be pulled down by Heinzen. Ball up underneath. Lays it up. Bucket good. Addison Engelhardt now with 12, and it's 37-30. As Berwick brings it across, almost picked off there. Jensen into the paint, scoops it back out. Kennedy, back Berwick. Berwick into the lane. Drop step left side, Stoddheim. Works it around, back Jensen. Jensen, right side, Kennedy. Open three, Berwick in and out. Rebound going to be pulled down by Heinzen. So Stoddheim almost with the steal. Schlaer up the right sideline finds Emily Schlaer. Schlaer coming in, the senior. Not sure if these two are seniors, or sisters, I mean, Kara Schlaer. They'll go baseline into the paint. Majerus up for two, no good, and she's going to be fouled. So 42 seconds to go in the quarter. And a 7-point ball game here for the Garrison Troopers. Free throw up, no good. Sadie Majerus will miss the first free throw. Jensen and Stoddheim will sit down. 42 seconds to go. 7-point ball game. Garrison leading it. Looking for another free throw here. Majerus' second one is no good. Rebound, Kennedy. Kennedy going to hand it off now for Berwick, trying to cut this lead down to 4 or 5. This trip down. Quick pass out right side, Morris. Left side, Berwick. Berwick now to the bounce pass, Shower. Shower cross court. It goes to Kennedy. Back out, Berwick. Saves it inbounds, almost overthrew it. Dangerous pass to Morris. Morris going to go right side into the paint. She goes, misses the layup. Rebound going to be lost out of bounds. Last touched by the Black Devils. So with 14 seconds to go here, Troopers will have the possession. Velka will come in for Ose. With 14 seconds to go in this third quarter. 7-point lead for Garrison. Going to go for the final shot here, obviously. They bring it up middle, of course, Heinzen. Heinzen now to left side, Majerus. 3-pointer, Schler is no good. Rebound, Berwick. 3 seconds, got to get going. Here comes your half-court shot, and she gets a foul. We got the foul here just before half. So the foul is going to be called on Sadie Majerus. Going to pick up her third. So with the, well, they're going to put 0.3 in the clock. That is the fifth team foul. So we got some free throws for Sienna Berwick. Berwick goes up there by herself with 0.3. They'll bring the Troopers back out of the huddle here for 2 shots. With 0.3 in the clock, so misses the second one. It's over with. Makes it. It's going to be over with as soon as they touch the basketball. First free throw, no good. Score remains 37-30. Getting ready for the fourth quarter here on KNDC. And HPS Stream Team, second one up, no good. And that will do it. End of three. The Troopers lead it 37-30. We'll take a break on KNDC Hettinger and HPS Stream Team back in 1 minute.
701.com, the gutter with a variety of birthday packages. You can rent out the game room or the virtual reality room and more. 567-6749. It's the gutter, a proud Nighthawk sports sponsor.
As West River doctors, we are dedicated to serving you and your family. We stand by your side in any circumstance, offering daily support at the heart of our commitment to care. Over the course of more than 3 decades, the West River Eye Center has been there for you. Starting with your child's first eye examination and their very first day of school, and extending well beyond. To us, you are family.
Stop in for great holiday savings now through the month of December at Napa Auto Parts and Egg Pro Machinery in Hettinger and in Lemon. Stop in and pick up your headlights, night vision, brilliant and vivid 2-pack bulbs. Save $10. They have Napa Extended Life Cooling System, anti-freezing coolant for all makes, all models, ready to use, starting at just $9.99. Pick up your Howes Fuel Additive Diesel Conditioner and Anagel, just $10.49. And Seafoam Concentrated Fuel Injector Cleaner, starting
South
at just
$4. Playing Grant County and Glen Ullin Hebron. Those games going on as well, along with Flasher Beach, Bowman, Richardson, Taylor. Final 4 games along with this one, Nighthawks, Troopers. Couple district matchups that will maybe affect the standings. Meeting set for tomorrow morning. Troopers with the basketball, start of the fourth quarter, lead it by 7 here. Working around will be Schler. Schler on the right side, working around the perimeter ball, loose through the floor, underneath it goes, and Monica's gonna come down. And they're going to call over and back, luckily, because we were either going to get a travel or a jump ball. It would have been Nighthawk ball either way. Stoddheim and Jensen will check in for Berwick and Kennedy. As Jensen bringing across the time stripe. Jensen left wing, backs around right side for Stoddheim. Jensen going to get her pass picked off. Nope, it's going to be batted back down. Left side, Morris. Morris into the lane. She goes up from 5. That is good. Monica Morris scoring the point. Yes, she has 11. 37-32. Cut down to 5 now. This has been the closest the Nighthawks have been for a while. Screen across, right side, cross court, left side is Engelhardt. Oh, big three, no good. Rebound Morris. So Morris going to hand it off for Jensen here. 1 minute gone by in the fourth, 37-32. Garrison by five. Jensen, left side Morris. Morris into the paint, backs it around right side. Jensen into the lane, little seven-foot floater. Up is good. Layla Jensen. 11 points, 37-34. Nighthawks now within three on this Black Devil throwback night. Cross court right side will be Heinzen for three, and she travels as she drains the three, but a travel is called. Turnover number 11. So we'll give the basketball back here to the Nighthawks at the 6:28 mark. And bring it in for Jensen. Jensen. Bringing it back left side now is Schauer. Schauer left wing. Now to the bounce pass, Jensen. Jensen into the lane. Kick pass out left side, Stoddheim. She'll penetrate. 10-footer on the way. That's no good. Tipped out of bounds by Garrison. Going to stay with the Nighthawks here with 6:11 to go. And trailing it by three is Hettinger Scranton. Black Devil throwback night tonight. Good to see all the old Black Devil stuff coming out of the closets. We saw the minor merchandise last week, the week before. Bounce pass Jensen. Nice little hook right side pass to Velka. Can't hold on to it. Taken away by Heinzen. And here she goes like a freight train. Lays it up no good. And a foul is going to be called on Morris. So with 6 minutes to go, we go to the free throw line. Once again, Abigail Heinzen. Heinzen tonight, 4 of 8 from the free throw line. 6 points tonight for Heinzen. As she'll have a couple free throws. Once again, Emily Schler, the only senior. Cameron Knorr, a junior, has not played tonight. This has been all sophomores and freshmen playing here this evening so far for Garrison. Ost checks back in. 6 minute mark of this one. 3 point lead for Garrison. First one no good. Second one no good again. But Garrison comes down with the rebound. Now a jump ball will be called. Possession arrow Nighthawks. It shouldn't have came to that. Nighthawks thought had a good box out, but too good of a box out because let one girl go through and get that rebound. Coming across will be Layla Jensen. Nice little fake going left side. She'll bring it across the time frame. It's got to be a reach in finally. And that's going to be her fourth. That's a big one. Kara Schler has picked up her fourth personal here. With 5:52 to go here in the fourth, 37-34. Garrison with the lead. Nighthawks with the basketball. They'll bring the basketball. Schauer brings it in. Jensen. Jensen on this left side. 5:50 to go in the ball game. Inside Jensen, left-handed hook. Going to be up no good. Rebound Heinzen. And here comes Kara Schler back the other way, playing with four fouls now. She'll kick it out left side. She's got to be careful if she doesn't get an offensive foul. Now a three up, no good. Rebound tip, Kara Schler. That's no good. Rebound underneath for Schler. Shot on the way. That is no good. And the rebound going to be pulled down finally by the Nighthawks. And quickly back comes Layla Jensen. Right side three. Big one coming for Morris, and she got it. Timeout Nighthawks. 5:19 to go in the fourth. Tied at 37. On Black Devil Throwback Night, we're back in 30.
With that Napa Auto Parts and Egg Pro Machinery in Hettinger and Lemon, saying good luck, Nighthawks.
At Backyard Mechanics, they take care of you like family because they live here right in your neighborhood. Fixing cars is what they do, but keeping you on the road and keeping your family safe is what they care about.
I want to thank all of our sports sponsors. Don't forget, we will have wrestling this weekend. It's the individual tournament. Going to be a long tournament up there in Kildare. I believe I'm going to have Cade Warbus and Rob Warbus bringing you the action again this weekend. In the midst of that, we'll have the district tournament game right around 2:30, I believe, will be the Nighthawks start time. And then we'll have the rest of the regional tournament. Then we'll cover Monday and Tuesday night of the district tournament in Glen Ullin. They'll bring the basketball. Kara Schler up the left sideline, picks up the dribble, back for Heinzen. Heinzen now to the right side for Emily Schler. Works it around three, on the way up Egelhart. That's no good. Rebound, Layla Jensen. So Jensen with the board, she'll cross it over right side for Morris. Morris finds Schauer into the paint, five-footer is good. Kelly Schauer wasn't sure if what she was going to do with that one. And she takes the lead, 39-37. Emily Schler up from five, that's no good. Tipped out and a foul from behind. Going to go on Sadie Majerus. So with 4:47 to go. What are we doing here? Could be white basketball. Nighthawks have the basketball. Garrison will go into a press. Kara Schler thought otherwise, or either that, or she was just trying to say, hey, you know what, let's maybe pull a trick out of the old hat. Jensen will get double teamed. Here comes Morris to the middle, left side, out for Ost. Back out Morris. Morris left wing. 4:40 to go in the fourth. 39-37. 2-point lead here for Hettinger Scranton. Into the corner, Morris. Another big three on the way. Air ball, rebound, Ost. Ost kicks it, Stadheim. Stadheim, back out Morris. Morris finds Stadheim, drops the basketball. Ball tipped out of her hands. Ball taken away. Ball loose, taken away by Morris. Back across comes Jensen. We can't blow it dead. I don't think you can blow it dead here while the Nighthawks have possession. Layla hit the three. So the bucket is no good. So we're going to have to put some time back on that shot clock, I think, too. Either got stepped on or hit with Sadie Majerus. Nope, that is Emily Schler. So with 4:17 to go here in the quarter. So Schler will sit down. There really wasn't a foul there either. It was just she went down, she rolled, and the Nighthawks took the basketball away from her. And I think as they were going away from her, either somebody stepped on her or hit her in the face. And she's sitting down to 4:17. Garrison in a 2-3 zone here. Schauer right in for Jensen. Layla across the time stripe. And this game means a lot. It's a non-district game, but going to get you momentum into the district tournament. As Jensen, who just hit that three, was taken off of the board because of the official timeout. Morris for two. Morris drove the baseline, 41-37. Nighthawks now lead it by four, 41-37. Back across up left side, three. Majerus, oh, she banks it home. Sadie Majerus now with six, 41-40. Back across comes Layla Jensen. Jensen across the time stripe. Back across off the wing right side is Schauer. Finds Jensen. Open three. Yes. Just rolled it across the rim is Layla. 44-40. Back across comes Kara Schler. A 4-point lead for the Nighthawks. Schler going to lose the basketball. Timeout going to be called with 3:19 to go in the ballgame. Nighthawks lead it by four. We'll take a 60 and be back.
Nighthawks will provide the security your family needs to keep you protected on the road. To learn more about what Backyard Mechanics can do for you, call Kenny at 701-567-2979. I trust them, and I think you should too.
Consolidated Business Solutions, along with GNET Fiber Technology and local support, can give your business the edge. Fiber solutions with symmetrical speeds up to 1 gig provide the fastest, most reliable internet available. Business Class Voice delivers custom options and plans to fit every business. And Consolidated's video keeps your customers informed and entertained. Contact our experienced team today. Consolidated Business Solutions. Let us exceed your expectations.
More than ever, your business or farm needs a local banker.
3:19 remaining in this one on HPS Stream Team and KNDC 1490 AM 106.7 FM. Across the way is Kara Schler, 25 on the shot clock. First, going to bring the inbounds. Cross court left side. Schler up for three, got it. Kara Schlaer now with 12, 44-43, 1 point ball game. Across the time stripe comes Jensen. Jensen now to the top of the key. Works it around right side, Schauer. Schauer finds Morris. Quick pass out, Jensen. Jensen double teamed. Looking up for Schauer. Cross court it goes to Stadheim. Stadheim looking 7-footer. Nope, Oss kicks it back out. Jensen on the way from 19. No good. Rebound going to be pulled up by Kara Schlaer. Loose basketball comes out for Jensen. Jensen with the steal. Turnover number 13 now. As Layla has the basketball, could pull the trigger at any time. Hands it back now for Morris. Morris into the lane. Floater from 7. That is good. Monica Morris making it 46-43. Another timeout here with 2.5 to go here in this fourth quarter. A 30-second timeout. We'll keep it here. As we said, nothing going on Thursday. There are district play-in games in District 5, which is us. That's on Thursday. Friday, the boys will be in action on Friday night. A lot of district games going on. Hettinger Scranton will be hosting Harding County in Scranton. That'll be a 7 o'clock start time. You can hear the varsity action right here on KNDC. Then on Saturday, we mentioned the region individual tournament along with the one district basketball game. That's going to be right around 2:30 in the afternoon Mountain Time. With 2.5 to go in this one, here we go. Garrison with the basketball will bring it in. Left side, Addison Engelhardt. Engelhardt works it across the time stripe. The eighth grader underneath it to go. Majerus, who's the foul? Jensen? They're going to get Layla Jensen on the foul. I missed the foul. I didn't see it. Sadie Majerus will go to the free throw line for 2 shots. First of 2 on the way is up and good. Sadie 1 of 3 from the free throw line tonight. Majerus back. She was 0 for 2 her first trip. She has 2 threes. She has 7 points. Second one is good again. So 8 points for Majerus, 46-45. Across the time stripe comes Layla Jensen. Jensen across the time stripe, right side down the 2:15. Kicks it back right side, Schauer, top of the key. Stadheim up 3, no rebound, Oss. Oss nowhere to go, has to kick it back out, and a double dribble is going to be called on Oss. We'll give the basketball back here. It'll be turnover number 18. With 2 minutes here in the fourth quarter, 46-45. Bringing across now will be Kara Schlaer. Schlaer, the sophomore. Quick pass up. Wow, quick trigger finger on that one. No good. Rebound, Layla Jensen, and here come the Nighthawks. Quickly back comes Jensen. Numbers has Morris in the corner, but she's going to go take it up for 2. Layla Jensen giving the Nighthawks a 3-point lead, 48-45. Back across comes Kara Schlaer, back down the other, missed it. Got her own boards, and no, a foul. I think they're going to get Morris on that one. Monica will pick up her third. And back to the free throw line goes Kara Schlaer. Schlaer tonight, 12 points. Once again, Schlaer a sophomore, one of their top athletes with 12. Jensen tonight, the junior, with 16, I believe. Free throw is good. If I can re-add real quickly. Yep, 16 points for Layla. 19 points for Monica Morris. Free throw up, no good. Rebound on the floor. Garrison falls out of bounds with it. And a timeout on the floor with a minute 32 to go here in the fourth. 48-46, Nighthawks by 2. We'll take a break, be back in 30.
Dakota Bank meets that challenge head on. Whether you need financing to operate and grow, insurance to reduce your risks, cash management and Visa card services, or trust and wealth management expertise, Dakota Bank is here for you. Call, click, or come in. Learn more at dakotabank.com or search online for business banking. Dakota Bank, member FDIC. Insurance and trust are not FDIC insured.
At Dakota Western Bank, they know ag banking. Found in 1910, their roots are tied to the land here in southwest North Dakota. They have the know-how to contribute to your success. They stand with you. visit dwb.bank or stop by for a visit at one of our locations in Bowman, Rames, Scranton, Hettinger, or Regent. Member FDIC, it's Dakota Western Bank.
These days, credit cards come in lots of colors.
Stars, stripes, platinum, plaid, but after that, they're all pretty much the same.
Not ours. At the credit union, we offer very competitive rates on our credit cards. That's a design feature that's easy to appreciate.
That's smart shopping.
That's member serving.
Have the work cut out for them. Try to get anywhere from 6 to 9 kids to that state tournament in wrestling. So it'll be interesting. That's coming up on Saturday. All right, so Garrison has the basketball, right baseline. A minute and a half to go here in the fourth. 48-46, Nighthawks by 2. Coming across, inbounding will be, well, Rhyme is there now. Kara Schler, what are we waiting for? All right, Schler will inbounds. A couple screens being set up. That's a moving screen, nothing called. Rhyme out back right side. Back and across underneath. Heinzen in from 5. That's no good. Rebound, Ose. So the minute 20 to go. Coming across will be Jensen. Layla Jensen across the time stripe. One-on-one to the right wing. 25 on the shot clock. Quick pass out left side. Moore. She pulls the trigger on. Oh, bingo! Monica Morris hitting another big three. She's into the 20s now. And now a three on the other end, no good from Heinzen, and Kelly Schauer going to watch that thing go out of bounds with 53 seconds to go. Monica Morris, 21 points tonight. She will bring the inbounds to Layla Jensen. 5-point lead here, 51-46. Cross court right side will be Morris. Morris to the bounce pass, Jensen. Layla works it back with 42 seconds to go. Back right side, Schauer, 20 on the shot clock. So they're going to take, they could take it down to about 17 seconds. And the coach just yelling at one girl, telling them to go out and get it. Now Jensen's going to penetrate, floater from 10, score it. Exclamation point, Layla Jensen. 7-point lead, cross court they come. Kara Schler for 3, that's no good. And the rebound going to be pulled down on the floor. On the floor, jump ball. Not sure how Schler ended up on the floor, but with 9 seconds to go, the Nighthawks are going to knock off a team that's receiving votes in the state polls. 53-46, inbounds. They work it. There's a travel, but nothing called. 3 in the way, no good. Rebound pulled out for Majerus. Taken away by Stottheim. They'll bring the basketball to Morris, and that's it. The Nighthawks will upset the Garrison Troopers here tonight in a regional matchup. 53-46, a 23-point outburst for the Nighthawks in the fourth quarter. Big win for the Nighthawks and Black Devil Nation as it's throwback night for the Black Devils. We'll take a 1-minute timeout on KNEC and HPS Stream Team. Let's take a break. Be back in 60.
Insured by NCUA.
Encompass Therapy has exciting news. We have added orthotics assessment and fitting to our clinic. Paul Hendrickson grew up in the area and is an experienced orthotics and prosthetics designer. He has a state-of-the-art fabrication lab right here in Scranton, North Dakota. He offers a wide range of the newest materials and techniques to make orthotics just right for you. Call 701-567-8910 today to make an appointment. Welcome, Paul Hendrickson.
2 big scores tonight for the Nighthawks. We'll run those down for you real quickly. Leading the way for the Nighthawks, 21 points for Monica Morris, 18 for Layla Jensen, 2 for Kelly Schauer, 2 for Sienna Berwick, 6 for Kinley Stottheim, 4 for Vanessa Ost. Nighthawks turned the basketball over 19 times this evening. For the Troopers, 15 turnovers. They were led. 13 points for Kara Schler, 12 points for Addison Egelhart. Emily Schler with 1, 6 for Rhyme, 6 for Heinzen. That's it for the Troopers. Once again, the Nighthawks outscored the Troopers 23-9 in the fourth quarter. What a ball game for the Nighthawks. They were down for a majority of it. Trailed at halftime 30-20, 37-30 at the end of three, and pick up a big win. Once again, scoring 23 points in that fourth quarter. That's going to wrap it up. We're going to send it back to the studios. And when we come back, we'll have more of your favorites. Also want to remind you, don't forget, we'll have tomorrow night, Thursday night off. We'll watch some play-in games. And then Friday night, you can hear the boys game on KNDC in Scranton. And regional tournament action on Saturday from Kildare, along with the girls' first-round game in Glen Ullin. So a lot of sports coming up. We'll cover as much as we can. Want to thank all of our great sports sponsors bringing you tonight's action. Once again, Nighthawks win it here tonight, 53-46 over the team receiving votes in the state poll, 53-46.
Did this activity, and we're gonna do it next month. So the kids are super excited for us. So.